Hey guys, if you enjoy the Drunken Peasants podcast, be sure to go to audibletrial.com/drunkenpeasants to get your free audio book. They have books like The God Delusion or Mr. Mercedes by Stephen King. Also, 150,000 other titles to choose from. So be sure to check that out. It supports the show and you get a free audiobook in the process. So what the fuck do you have to lose?
Coming to you live from the frigid armpit of America, this is the Drunken Peasants Podcast with Ben and TJ, bringing you opinions of the news from an altered perspective.
Fuck it!
Say, man, you got a joint? No, man.
I don't have facts to back this up.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
What the fuck are you talking about, atheist?
It's okay.
You're nothing, KJ. Okay. You're garbage.
Okay. I just want to be light.
You're garbage.
And now, here are your hosts, Ben and TJ.
We'll do it live. We'll do it live. Fuck it. Do it live. Fucking thing sucks.
Welcome to the Drunken Peasants Podcast, where we DP the fuck out of the news. I'm Ben.
And I'm Sickly TJ.
Sickly TJ.
Aww.
Yeah. And we have a guest.
Yeah.
From the channel Tech Syndicate, Pistol. Yes. Welcome
Hello.
To the show, Pistol.
Thank you for having me.
Sure, no problem.
Ben is pistol whipped.
That is actually a very common thing among the people who watch my stream, say pistol whipped.
Yeah, I could see that. But Ben is one of them.
I am. Yes. I'm one of them now.
Yep. Pistol whipped.
He will obey you. Whatever commands you give him, he will obey.
Is this, like, are we getting into kinky shit now or what?
I don't know if that's where your mind went.
That's what it sounds like you're
this
going.
I don't know. You know, I'm just saying the truth. And
that's not really my personality.
People can interpret it as they please.
So for any of our viewers who don't know the channel or what you do, do you want to give them the rundown?
Well, we're a technology channel. We do like a lot of hardware reviews and stuff like that. And we have a weekly show called The Tech where a lot of politics are covered and stuff like that. Although I'm personally not huge into politics, but, you know, we do cover
mainly,
a lot of that.
Mainly funded by the Jesuits, correct?
Yeah, exactly. The Jesuits. But I do a lot of the editing and camera work and the lighting for it. So I do a lot of the background stuff. So there are a lot of people who watch Tech Syndicate who don't even know who I am. But I do a lot of the background stuff. So
that's kind of like what I do, only I'm also there, like, in front of the camera. And TJ is just
kind of am.
Yeah,
Our newer show that we kind of have sort of.
TJ just kind of shows up and is like, Ben, are you done yet? And if I'm like, no, he's like, fuck you, motherfucker, and he slaps me around a couple times.
Sure, whatever. I told Ben yesterday, like, Ben, I'm sick, and he's like, still gonna be able to do the show or what? I'm like, he's like, you know, we can't. It's hard to schedule things with so much uncertainty. I'm like, I'll be sure to let the virus know, Ben. Thanks.
Cry, baby.
The virus cares.
Yeah.
Hashtag TJ's a pussy. Yeah.
That's true.
He is. But the thing about TJ is that he's sick, like, every month.
No.
Yes.
I'm not sick every month.
Okay, every other month.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
That's bullshit. I don't even remember the last time I was sick. What are you talking about?
I don't know.
It's very rare.
No, I guess it's very rare.
I mean, like,
says.
Well, I mean, like, there's times when I'm sick because I, like, drank too much or ate too much.
That's like every week for me.
Yeah. But, you know.
It's a different kind of sick.
Yeah.
It's rare that I get some kind of, like, weird cold or flu bullshit going on. Which is what's happening now.
Or like the new Marilyn Manson album comes out and TJ's like, I'm sick. I can't come in and YouTube's doing maintenance tonight. So, but But I'll show up anyway, but Scotty's a pussy, and he's pussy whip for not showing up, even though I wanted to not show up, too, because of Marilyn Manson.
Oh.
Yeah.
You know.
It sucks that Scotty's not here. I'm going to play one anyway. I don't even care if he's not here.
Do it.
Hey, Scotty. I want to fuck you up the ass.
Da, 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 da.
Yeah. I had a whole bunch of them lined up, too.
Fucking Scotty.
I know. I'm going to play one more.
Hey, Scotty. Go and drink your dad's sperm.
Let's just play them all. Fuck it.
Okay. All right. We'll play the next one, too.
Do it live.
Hey, Scotty.
Let's rape Scotty in the ass. Let's rape Scotty in the ass. Fuck, motherfucker. Ow.
It's the first one I think actually had Scotty in it.
You think right now, Scotty? Now you're on camera. Now it's your job to entertain the people.
Suck my dick, TJ.
Alright.
Alright.
Da, 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 da.
That was one of the better ones I had heard.
Oh, yeah.
How long ago was that?
I don't know. It looks like we were in Macomb, Illinois, so probably like 3 or 4 years ago.
Well, he was like, suck my dick, TJ, and you're like, all right.
All right. No problem. There any more?
Yeah. Yeah, there's a couple more. I had a whole bunch. I was like, Scotty, all right, you know, because I thought he was going to be here.
Should have known better.
And why is he not here, TJ?
Because his fucking bitch-ass bitch girlfriend.
It's like I knew he would say it. And what's wrong with that, TJ?
Everything.
Hey, Scotty.
You don't deserve someone to suck your dick. You're a moron. But that's neither here nor there.
Okay.
That's neither here nor there.
It's neither here nor there.
Yeah. All right, one more.
Hey, Scotty.
Yeah, let me bob my head. Yeah, let me listen to Evolution. Evolution is a joke.
All right.
It's all true.
That guy's a joke.
Yeah.
No, he's awesome.
Yeah, he's right about everything. He humbled us.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Sorry.
Yeah.
He fucked us into submission.
There's one more.
Is there?
Hey, Scotty.
Leave me alone. Please.
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 Is he holding something or is he just doing like a weird claw thing?
I don't know.
Richard the Dick. Coughlin. Coughlin.
So, our first video is TJ. It's funny, I always say it's TJ's favorite, but there are so many. TJ loves all of these videos that we play here. He, sits around and watches them on his spare time. That's why.
Oh, yeah. That's me.
That's the reason why when TJ shows up, like, 10 minutes before the show starts, he's been sitting there watching these videos himself. TJ just sits around and watches YouTube all day.
Uh-huh. Yep. That's all true.
All right, so here's. I think it's relevant to what's been going on in recent days, though.
No,
so
it's not.
Here's our buddy Mario.
Nope. Fuck.
Best friend.
No. Why?
He's vigilant.
He's a Christian.
He's vigilant.
He's a truther.
Hey everyone, it's Vigilant Christian Mario, and you're here for another edition of Illuminati.
Mario, I'm going to give you a little bit of advice here. Your mic is way lower than your intro, and I have to turn it up way louder.
Hi, it's the Vigilant Christian Mario.
It's like when a commercial goes back to the show and the volume is totally different.
Yeah.
Yeah, the commercial's like, buy Pepsi! And then the show starts, it's like... Margaret, I miss you.
Exactly.
Like, fuck. Stick to one volume, you fuck. But
World
that's, you know, people always call me on that shit, too, though.
stars. So, in today's video, I wanted to report on Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt supporting their daughter's wish to be called John. Now, I'm just going to put a disclaimer out there at the start of this video. Many of you are about to be offended by what I'm about to say.
We're about to be offended.
I'm offended by like his general existence. So, like the things
something's
he has to say.
Satanic. Just so you know. Yep. No,
no, no, not
this
at
is,
all.
It's all satanic.
This is some more of that transgender Satanism. Just like the yoga Satanism or the Simpsons Satanism or the Family Guy Satanism or the Marilyn Manson Satanism or the...
You know, honestly, I can see the Marilyn Manson Satanism. It's more blatant.
But, I mean, like, I guess that at least in that case, there's, like, something more than just an absolutely tenuous connection. But even still, it's stupid. Even there.
So I just want to warn you, I am about to share the Christian worldview. And many of you, as I've noticed in the comment section, are offended by this worldview.
Yep.
So I would just ask that you understand that we live in a free country, and I have all the right in the world to my YouTube channel.
No one even denies anyone's right to fucking say anything, all right?
So. I know, it's funny how he's kind of like,
I have the right to do this. It's like, that's not in question, so shut up.
He's already defensive.
Right, right. And he makes it seem like the fact that people criticize him is them saying he doesn't have the right.
Right. Like, I mean, I can sit here all day and call you a stupid piece of shit and an asshole. It doesn't mean I want you censored.
Right. And we invited him on. I even have a voice message from Mario saying, hey, you know,
it's
I want
me.
That's exactly how he sounded. And he was too busy, you know, doing plumbing work to come on the show, so...
I don't get it. What do you mean plumbing? What are you talking about?
Cleaning pipes.
What?
The Vigilant
Plumbing. I don't get it, Ben.
YouTube channel.
I don't fucking get it, Ben.
A Christian perspective and worldview. I am very sorry if that offends you. We need to get along. Some of your views may offend me, but that's okay. I'm not going to spend all day on your YouTube channel or your pages wasting my time hating on you. I got better things to do, and I'm sure you do too. So
no, you don't.
I'm going to give you a moment here. I'm just going to be silent for a moment. Go ahead and turn off the video and go and maybe do something more productive if the Christian worldview.
That's a good idea.
No, TJ, I think we're going to keep playing the video.
Is about to be offensive to you. Okay, so now that everyone that's still listening understands that we're going to look at the Christian way of viewing this, let's go ahead and do that. This is not the way the Christian parents should encourage their children at all. Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt failed as parents from the Christian perspective. The Christian perspective understands something, that there is a satanic agenda in the world today. I have covered it in a previous video called The Satanic Agenda to Confuse the Sexes, Exposed, Created Equal but Different. Here I've shown that Satan, through the Illuminati, has an agenda to confuse the sexes. I talked about the use of fashion and things like this. If you're looking in Vogue type of fashion these days, you're going to see that the men are very feminine looking. They're even wearing dresses, as I'm showing you on your screen here. And you're going to see a progression of this, a very subtle progression of men looking more like women and women being more encouraged.
Runway shows
like
have
men.
Always done very strange things. Like, that's very tame from some other things I've seen on runway shows.
It doesn't matter. His narrative of Satan is everywhere, Satan is always doing these nefarious things in every corner of our society, is never going to go away.
Yeah.
I mean, even that is not new. I mean, you know, we could go back to the 1950s and find the equivalent of the Vigilant Christian talking about how Elvis is satanic. I mean, it's not...
Everything's satanic.
Everything's satanic. Yeah.
My keyboard is satanic.
And we're definitely satanic. The drunken peasants. The drunken peasants basically sucks Satan's dick. Wow. Already you fail, Ben. Already you fail.
He left.
You know, no. This is the thing. Hold on. No. Shut up.
I can explain.
Oh, his tiny bladder, right?
Shut up. No.
No.
You're not explaining. Because... A few minutes ago, Ben pointed to like an empty beer bottle and said, "That was my last beer before St. Patrick's Day or whatever, and I'm like, oh, well.
This isn't beer.
Oh, it's not a beer.
It's a cider?
It looks, that's
it
bullshit.
It has the same, if not more, percentage.
And he fucking comes back, and he's like, he's already he's got a new one. He's a liar.
It just tastes better.
You can't trust
it. It does taste better.
I love
it. I said it was my last beer.
Can't trust him. Can't trust him.
That was his last beer. Now he's going to have 20,000 ciders.
Right. You fail.
It's my last beer.
It's funny how she was like, is it about his weak bladder? Nah. I did leave the room and come back.
Yeah, I have this stream up on another monitor. And I saw you were gone.
He's got a bladder the size of like a thimble, basically.
I'm guilty of that too. It's okay.
Some shows Ben will leave like 28 times.
Once you break the seal, it's all over.
Right. My seal is permanently broken.
And you see, Satan is trying to confuse
Ben does
the sexes.
Nothing but piss.
We were created equal but different, and it's beautiful when we embrace the differences that were created, because the differences when a man and woman actually come together harmonize with each other. The things that the woman has, the man doesn't, and vice versa. And when they come together, they make a beautiful blend. One flesh union. It's awesome. But Satan wants to take that away from people. He wants to make men and women completely the same. Even when you just look at it from a biological standpoint, it's not true.
Women
are different.
I love how in this narrative, like, the whole transgender thing is like apparently being foisted upon unwilling participants, you know?
It is.
Like, I'm a male who's confident and strong in my masculinity and da da da. Nope. Satan says now you gotta wear a dress, pretty boy. You a girl now. Mandatory transgenderism, bitch. Satan's plan. Like, what? Where is that happening? Nowhere?
So
okay.
Satan's plan overrides God's plan, is what he's
saying?
It
does. Yes.
Satan is always winning in our society, according to him. So I guess Satan must be more powerful.
You gotta side with the winning side, right?
Yeah, I'm going with Al Pacino. I don't know about you guys.
Look at the biology behind it. A man is stronger, hairier, whatever, a woman is softer, more nurturing. There's differences, and let's embrace those differences. God doesn't view those differences.
Those are pretty stupid examples of differences. I would have gone with more concrete stuff like Y chromosomes and, you know.
Technically, humans are hairier than gorillas. It's just our body hair is significantly shorter than theirs.
And thinner.
Yeah, but we have more of it.
I guess that makes sense.
Bad. Satan wants you to view those differences as bad, and then tie in this whole lie that because we're different, we're not equal. It's garbage, nonsense. So just be vigilant. There.
What about the equality between men and women in the Bible itself?
Right, that's what I was just thinking. It's like Satan wants to get rid of equality. It's like read the Bible sometime, dipshit.
Yeah, he never actually talks about the Bible. He just takes Christianity and tries to link it to these crazy
conspiracy theories.
He probably
hasn't read it.
I don't know.
Some like modern thing Christians. Is satanic because of this, and, you know, Satan wants to do this, and somehow I've figured out Satan's entire evil agenda, even though I'm a moron.
Yeah.
He is a satanic agenda to confuse the sexes, and unfortunately this satanic agenda has taken a hold of the child of Angelina and Brad here, who is now extremely confused. The Bible says that God is not the author of confusion. So when we're looking at a child who is confused,
he doesn't seem confused. He seems pretty sure of what his gender is.
You know, I mean, like, even if the kid one day says, oh, that was just a phase, whatever, they're not doing any harm letting the kid identify as he wants to identify right now. It's not like they're going into like the surgical phase or some shit.
Yeah, I mean, like,
hormone treatments. This is just allowing the kid to present how he wants to at this time. I don't see the fucking harm. I don't see how it's really affecting anybody, but according to Vigilant Christian, it's all part of Satan's fucking evil plan to control humanity and make us all bow down to the Illuminati will.
About their identity, It's very sad. This is the god of this world, Satan, the fallen one, who is just confusing the daylights out of the world to the point where, look, I mean, boys don't even know how to be boys and girls don't know.
That's
how
bullshit.
To be girls.
That's bullshit.
Now,
that's bullshit. That's
obviously
fucking bullshit.
Children look to runway shows to learn how to be. Because that's a thing.
99 point whatever percent of kids never have these sorts of gender issues, okay? It's a small, small minority. The way he's talking about it, you would think, like, kids don't even know what the fuck they are anymore. Boys
I never
are...
even thought about my gender until I was, like, you know, 12, 13 years old because I didn't care.
Right.
It didn't matter.
Sure. So, I mean, like I said, most kids don't even have these fucking issues at all. But for the ones that do, is it really that big of a deal to fucking support them and create a fucking nurturing environment? Is that really so fucking evil and satanic? I mean, fuck. Ben's gone again.
Well, obviously nurturing is a satanic act.
Everything is satanic.
Yeah, everything.
Everything. It's like, I think Vigilant Christian, you ever seen like Waterboy with fucking Adam Sandler from back
yeah.
in the day? You remember
Bobby
his,
Boucher?
Remember his mom was like,
it's the devil. Everything's
the devil. Foosball's the devil.
Yeah, just replace Bobby Boucher's Cajun mother with fucking Vigilant Christian's Quebecois mother. And that's how you got it.
There you go.
Yeah. Because apparently Mario was raised Quebecois. So.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
There are some objections out there that people are born this way. I'm going to object to that and say that, yeah, sure, okay.
On the basis of science,
way,
surely.
There's a reason that people are being born with a very high level of estrogen, and we're seeing very feminine boys. The fact is, there are chemicals that are being put in absolutely everything these days.
Oh, come on. Come on.
So is it chemicals making the gays? Is that what it is?
It's oh the government. God. The Illuminati government making the gays.
And you know, it's funny. Mario, the Vigilant Christian, is Canadian. But when he speaks of the government, he speaks of like...
the American government.
Yeah, and only...
and American media.
I've never heard him address the Canadian government in any... I could have missed that video, but... I never really hear him talk about Canada's government, so
that's because he realizes that Canada is just a glorified state.
EA, which raises estrogen and everything. I mean, you go to the bathroom, and after you're done and you wipe yourself, you just wiped on BPA.
Hey, buddy, it's the washroom. Get it right.
So basically, his theory. Hold on. Let's just wrap our minds around this for a second. You wipe your ass, there's BPA in the toilet paper, you get estrogen via your asshole that
yeah.
turns you into, you know, a gay
it's
person
kind of like
or a trans chugging. Person, you know?
It's kind
so,
of like butt chugging with estrogen.
Oh, yeah. Can you just pour this estrogen down my asshole, please?
TJ, I already told you no once. Oh, are you talking about Mario?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, Ben. Didn't mean to confuse you. Yeah. I know we've been over that territory many times.
Fuck.
My bad.
It's insane. Everything you touch has BPA these days. So what's happening is these chemicals are interacting with humanity, changing us at a hormonal level, and this is having an effect on the sexuality of young boys and girls because they're confused. Take a whole bunch of hormones. As a woman, take a whole bunch of testosterone, and if you're a man, take a whole bunch of estrogen and see what
now
happens.
Now I think the Vigilant Christian doesn't wipe his ass.
He's scared.
Because he's paranoid. Yeah, he just walks around with a shitty ass.
Ain't gonna feminize me.
He just walks around crop dusting people all day.
Oh,
like.
God.
Oh.
No, actually, when we first talked about the Vigilant Christian, he was like, hey, you know, you guys never got laid. I got laid all the time. That's the only reason, you know, you have a problem with me is because I was awesome and you guys were nerds. So.
Yeah, that is the problem.
Yeah, I know.
Now, this story about Shiloh wanting to be called John, isn't that a girl who wants to be a boy?
Yeah.
Is that this whole mom? So he's kind
yeah.
of, like, I don't know, arguing against himself right now because he's saying all these things put estrogen in you, but it's a girl wanting to, I don't know.
Yeah, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense.
It would be, testosterone.
Yeah, he's like contradicting himself, basically.
Yeah.
It doesn't make any sense, but I mean, his thought process doesn't make sense to begin with.
Shouldn't it be the case that, you know, it would ultra feminize her or something? She'd just be like super. I'm like a super girl now. I'm like ten times as much feminine as I would have been naturally, thanks to the BPA and the toilet paper.
Yeah, and everything else. More, so you'd think that.
There you fucking go.
So this is what's going on. There was, in fact, scientific studies that were done that what they would do is take people that were professing homosexuals and they would verify them on a hormonal level to see if there was any imbalances. 90% of the time there was a hormonal imbalance, and when they would fix the hormonal imbalance, the individual's sexuality would fall back into natural form. And the natural form is for boys to love.
No, that's not even true. That's just made up entirely. Yep. I'm sorry, but that's like utter falsehood. I'd like to see this fucking study.
A girl and a girl to love a boy. That's the natural way. But because of the chemicals and all this confusion and the estrogen being manipulated with, the testosterone being manipulated with, humans are born in this ultra confusing world. And then the media doesn't make it any better. The schools don't make it any better. They're just...
Pistol, you should stop vaping. That shit's bad for you, okay?
Brainwashing people to, oh, you're born that way. Even Lady Gaga's making songs, born that way. Yeah, you're born into a world where there is a war against you. They're using food, water, air to poison you, to raise your estrogen, to destroy men in our culture.
Is that why I've been growing breasts? Because I drink water?
I have big breasts, actually. So.
Fuck, man.
It's the water.
Do you drink? It's, yeah, it comes from the water, damn it.
It wasn't the fried chicken. It was the water.
Yep.
So that men don't rise up, become the leaders of their homes and their families and their communities and their nations, and really do something. So this is the agenda, and we're born that way, but yeah, there is a war going on against humanity with chemicals. So there you have it, the Christian perspective on this issue. I know it's not.
So wait, hold on.
I like how he says it's
miscellaneous chemicals.
Right.
Wait, the Christian perspective is chemicals and BPA and the toilet paper, and they're poisoning us with the air. What is the biblical support for any of that?
Yeah,
how is that the Christian point of view? That's not the Christian point of view. That's your fucking wacky conspiracy theory.
I bet I could find a bunch of Christians that think this is utter bullshit.
Plenty.
Easily.
Plenty. Next.
Mario, come on our show. You know, we offered to have you on our show, and you declined.
He'll probably cry. He's not
going to
do it.
He'll cry tears.
He made a video saying
BPA.
He wanted to come on, so, yeah.
Estrogen tears.
Well, saying something and then doing something are totally different.
Yeah, it's true.
Nah.
So we're going to watch a little bit of this, not all of it, because it's kind of repetitive, but it is very hilarious. It's our friend, the Cloud Guy.
Cloud disappear.
Hey, this is a cloud control video by Keith Chase in August 2012. See these two clouds, kind of fluffy clouds?
Yeah.
I'm going to try to make the clouds into a square-shaped cloud.
I'm going to try to make it a square-shaped cloud
by using my psychic powers.
Square-shaped cloud.
Cloud, become a square-shaped cloud. Cloud, become a square shape.
Cloud, become a square shape.
Change into a square shape.
I doubt the cloud can hear him. It's pretty far away.
Become a square shape, cloud.
It's just to help him focus his psychic powers.
Okay.
Become a square shape, cloud. Cloud, become a square shape,
cloud.
Cloud, become a square
shape.
Oh, God. It's like... Oh, it's 6.5 minutes, basically, of him saying, Cleo.
Does the cloud become a square shape?
He wants to do it with both of these clouds? He wants them to conjoin
and become a square shape? There you go. Look.
That's a square if I have ever seen one.
I would immediately identify that as a square.
Be like, hey, look, there's a perfect square in this guy. Oh, jeez.
Cleed, become a square shape, Cleed. Cleed, become a square shape, Cleed. Cleed.
Okay, he's been doing this for like the past like 5 minutes.
Become a square shape, Cleed. Cleed, become a square shape, Cleed.
If anything, it's a circle.
It looks more circular at this point.
Yes. Cleed, become a square
shape. Pretty soon it'll be a
square. Cleed, solidify the square. Cleed, become a
solidify
square.
The square.
Solidify or a sheet of ice will fall on you.
Solidify the square. When, if the cloud was solid and it fell to Earth, it would probably hurt some people.
Yeah, it would just be an ice block that would just fall.
Cleed, become a square shape. Cleed. Cleed, become a square shape. Cleed. Cleed, become a square shape. Cleed.
You know, he recorded this video. He could have just, like, deleted it and been like, fuck, that cloud didn't become a square shape.
he went out of his way to upload it instead. Yeah. I've seen similar videos to this guy where they, like, try to put holes in clouds with telekinesis or whatever. They try to put holes in them.
I wonder how many of these videos, like, at least in this one, they kind of conjoined into something that you could, like, say, like, oh, well, it's kind of a square, sort of.
Well, they
were
right next to each other. They were kind of bound.
Right.
To
but I just, I wonder how many times he's made these videos and the cloud doesn't do anything like what he says at the beginning. Hey, you know, I want
if
you just,
a dragon.
You know, the funny thing is, if you just film clouds, you could just put in whatever audio you wanted
right.
to afterwards.
Yeah, you could
just
voice
like,
it over.
It's kind of like back
like,
in the day.
Look,
with
I'm fucking magical.
Right.
Look at my powers. I have cloud kinesis, bitch.
It's become a squeeze.
The most useless superpower ever.
Hashtag cloud kinesis.
Like cloud
shape,
clear.
Become a square shape, clear.
Do clouds like? Do they prefer certain accents? Because he says things certain ways when he's doing this.
Yeah, I don't know. I could be wrong. It almost sounds like a New York accent.
Well, when he was like prefacing in the beginning of the video, he would say cloud, but when he starts talking to it, he says clued.
Become a square shape.
Become a square shape.
I'm gonna stop. And that's the end of the video.
It didn't become a square shape.
There's no corners.
He'll faint if he doesn't.
Yeah.
He doesn't breathe very much.
Too much. So like, okay, let's just do like if we did a poll and we just took a picture of this cloud and we're like, what shape is this cloud? I think you're gonna get like 0% of respondents answered square.
Yeah, it's very round.
It is very round.
Yeah, so
it kind of looks like the evil fish in Mario 3 to me, but maybe that's just because we listen to
it. Oh, the big-ass one that chases you?
Yeah.
Oh, God, I hate that fucking thing.
Yeah.
The only thing worse than that in the Mario games is the guy that rides the cloud. That
I
throws
hate
the
him.
Oh, that fucking
so
piece
annoying.
Of shit. Yeah, that guy
and he
sucks.
Throws the little spiky things down on you.
And you can't even kill
you
those
can
fuckers.
You can steal his cloud, though, and I would get
yes.
so excited
yeah.
when I'd steal his cloud. I'd be like, fuck you.
But then it just evaporates, and then he comes back like 2 seconds later.
Well,
like,
because
it's me
said,
again.
You disappear, and then it goes away, and, you know.
Clue, disappear.
Telekinesis.
Clue, disappear.
Here's a clip from a Nigerian Christian TV show where someone pranked it, and I guess they were like writing letters or emails to this guy, and he reads them on the show about people who came to God and whatever. So here we go.
There's someone who's written a story here. It's a long one. He says, I'm a newly born again Christian and would like to share my story of salvation with you.
Okay, so this is a born-again Christian story of salvation that he's about to read. I wonder if any of you will find it familiar.
I was born in West Philadelphia and also raised
I know what this
I
is
spent
already.
Most of my days playing basketball on a playground and also chilling out and relaxing. But then one day, a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my living area.
Oh, man.
I ended up getting into a fight, which terrified my mother. As a result, she sent me away from West Philadelphia to the most peaceful area of Bel Air.
Oh, I saw this a long time ago. Yeah. I remember this.
Oh, okay. Fresh. Okay. And I think there's some Mongolians on the system.
He's like, all right, I.
It's from a comedy show.
Okay. You know what? Let me take this call. Joyce from.
What's happening now?
Some. He's gonna read something else.
My inspiration in life.
Yeah.
Is a man I met in Nigeria called Ben Kenobi. He taught me so much about the force that spirituality has. It can be used for good and it can be used for bad. There is a light and a dark to everything. It's up to us to make sure that the light side of things outweighs the dark side. But in the kingdom of God, it's all about light. No darkness at all. So,
yes.
He doesn't catch on.
No.
But people go over and get powers from the enemy. And that's darkness, really. I helped him spread his message as best as I could for summer. For the summer, I was there. But one man with a particularly sharp tongue attacked his beliefs one day and he disappeared shortly after. He believed in midichlorians.
midichlorians. It's like, oh my God. Wow. How hard can you be trolled?
Trolled all of us and created all of us.
Pretty hard, apparently.
He didn't think that the force of spirituality and midichlorians went hand in hand. Ben taught me that we must always try to live in harmony with all other forces of the universe. I don't think that is biblical because...
No, it's not
biblical. Good observation there.
You can't live in harmony with
other forces that are contrary to the power of God. You can't. Always, the power of God, according to the Bible, is superior to any other power. So, and that all other powers must bow to the power of God as illustrated in the Bible. So, I think you have to go check your doctrine and your...
You can't handle midichlorians, dude.
Can't Sorry. Handle it, bitch.
Here's another clip out of Africa. It's Eat Da Poo-Poo.
Oh, okay. Boy.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Pastor Dr. Martin Semper. I'm here in the capacity as the chairman of the National Task Force Against Homosexuality in Uganda.
Okay, so you know it's going to be good. Just by what he just said.
Uganda. We are making legislation to make sure that sodomy and homosexuality never sees the light of legality in this land of the Pearl of Africa. I've taken time to do a little research to know what homosexuals do in the privacy of their bedroom. One of the
AKA
things they do is
watch gay porn.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. We have done research. It's like, you don't need to, it's not really.
You did research all night long.
I saw this one video. This guy, he took a big banana and put it in his butthole.
That's
Fuck
what
you,
they
man.
Do.
Anal leaking, where a man's anus is
anus.
Like this,
and the women are just like staring in bemusement.
Like, oh,
like, what?
Oh, yeah. I see.
She's kind of smiling. She doesn't
She's
look
like,
disgusted.
I want that.
That doesn't sound so bad.
The other person, like ice cream, and then what
ice cream, huh?
Even
it's like ice cream.
Now the other poo-poo's out.
Poo-poo.
And then they eat the poo-poo.
No,
they eat the poo-poo.
Not usually. Maybe some people.
Well, I mean, that's what he was searching for, obviously.
Scat porn.
Yeah.
The other one they do is they have a sex practice called fisting.
Oh. I love this.
I love his emphasis and his like his demonstration.
He's very excited about all this, you know.
He loves it.
I was on the internet all night last night.
Whoa, he's going elbow deep in that
shit. Oh yeah, he's like yeah.
He's elbow deep.
Feasting
into it, man. Literally into it.
Good thing he wore a short sleeve shirt that day.
It goes all into the anus all the way, and it is so painful. They have to take drugs, but they enjoy.
What?
They have to take drugs.
They have to take drugs.
You have to take drugs.
Like laxatives to make it like ice cream.
With a fist.
It's like ice cream. Fist. Soft serve chocolate ice cream.
Oh, God.
Now, if we have any children, please step out.
This is now? You could have fucking.
You just covered fisting.
I know. It's like you covered fisting and shit eating, but now it's like, now women and children leave.
Yeah.
I want to know what the fuck he's going to discuss now.
Who moved out? So I've done research.
Oh, here we go.
This is what they do. Number one, you can see a man here having sucked the other.
Wait, hold on. So he literally did just go look at gay porn.
Yeah, now he's showing it to everyone.
He's like, look at. He's got the best job to hide his obvious homosexuality. He's just like, yes, I am against them. That's why I have to look at this material.
Maybe it's his fetish to just show gay porn to a group of people and just see their reactions. He like gets
look at this.
He nuts.
And the other person is poo-pooing, and this one is eating the poo-poo all over the place. Tell me, when you have a law against homosexuality, do you say except eating poo-poo?
I like how he says poo-poo.
So apparently the only way to have gay sex is to eat shit, according to him.
All gay people eat shit. It's a well-known fact of life.
Hey, I mean, look at this guy sincerely. Bishop.
Look at it. Look at it. Behold the beauty of it.
We do not want this sickness. This is sick, and it's therefore deviant. We do not want it.
Now.
Seems like you kind of do want it, buddy.
He wants to at least watch it.
Yeah.
Start off by touching each other's genitals and smelling each other.
Now he's showing a bigger group of people.
He's like, yeah, this guy has the strangest job ever. He goes around showing explicit, hardcore, gay scat porn to people and be like, we do not want this!
Look at it! It's disgusting, look at it!
This one smears the poo-poo all over the other person's face. As if that is not enough, he puts the hand deeper! As Africans, we want to ask Barack Obama to explain to us, is this what he wants to bring to Africa as a human right to eat?
Hold on.
So even
Obama,
Africa blames Obama for everything.
Yeah, it's funny.
Thanks,
he
Obama.
He brings the shit porn
eating
to Africa.
Explain this, it. Obama. You fuck.
Eat the poo-poo of our children.
No! Kill the faggots! No!
That's the end of that clip.
So are they Christian or are they something else?
Probably Christian, I would guess.
Probably.
I would guess so.
Probably.
They're definitely not Muslim, and Christianity and Islam is what you'll find in Africa more than anything else. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just by the way they're acting, they seem like...
But the Bible like promotes slavery and things of that nature.
Oh, huh. Did you ever see our episodes with G-Man where he defends slavery?
Unfortunately.
To us? Yeah. So,
I voted no on that poll.
Y'all.
On having him back, I was like, no, please. I will not watch that episode.
You're my ally. I didn't want him back either, but Ben's like, let's just see what the audience wants.
It's kind of funny because, you know, When we were about to make the announcement that we were going to start doing the show 3 days a week, we lied to everyone and said, all right, our announcement is that Scotty is leaving and G-Man will now be a permanent part of the Drunken Peasants. And people actually believed us. It was pretty fucking hilarious.
Yeah. People also believed me when I went on the chat room the other day because, you know, everyone was like hating on Galen and shit. I was like, we're getting rid of the Drunken Peasants and we're changing it to the Galen Show.
And seriously though,
and some people were like, oh my God, please don't do that.
I want to address this now.
You'd be surprised at the stuff people believe when you just say it.
Oh yeah.
I want to address something now. Like, I've had people that are actually patrons of our Patreon and they say, if you have Galen or G-Man, either way, on again, I'm going to stop being your patron. It's like, you know, what if someone else said that to, like, Paul's ego? You think we're going to listen to them? I mean, it's like we're not just going to listen to people because they threaten to not give us money anymore.
Yeah,
it's, we're going to have whoever the fuck
we
want.
Whatever you want, you know. Right. The audience who wants to watch that, they will, you know, congregate and they will watch it. And if people don't like it, will leave, and then you have a viewer base.
Someone
that enjoy.
Someone in my my Reddit, right, my subreddit, said something to me about. Don't have Galen on, or don't do something or another. And I'm like, this isn't a democracy,
right? But Galen will be on again.
Like, this is not like this I is mean, not up
it's
for a vote.
Dictatorship,
right? We're the dictators. You guys are the subjects. You don't like it? Go watch something else. You know, I mean, we'll listen to our audience. We'll take
just
what they want into consideration for sure.
I think next time that we have Galen or G-Man on again, they will not be on at the same time.
I will say that Galen. Even after Galen signed off that night, he was disappointed in his performance because he was feeling really under the weather and shit.
Well, yeah, Galen has some health issues,
right?
So that's
so he was having a bad day, yeah. But you know, he still did the show and it was pretty good. But
yeah.
Anyway, moving on to whatever the next video is, I guess.
Oh, it's your buddy.
What buddy?
Stefan.
Ugh.
Stefan.
I think I know how to say his last name.
Okay,
so
go ahead.
Know.
Go ahead.
I think it's pronounced Molyneux.
Yeah, Molyneux. It is. You're right.
Is it?
Molyneux.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the only time on The Drunken Peasants that his name will be said correctly. Stefan Molyneux.
Stefan Molyneux.
Manure? Stefan Manure.
Yeah, just call him Manure.
I mean,
it's okay.
To come out against spanking in North America? is not an easy thing to do. Even now, it's ridiculous that it's not an easy thing to do. But you know,
doesn't he blame women
before,
for everything?
Oh yeah,
just everything. So it's
well,
like
when he's not pretending
Christian,
to be a woman himself.
Satanic. But to him,
yeah.
Everything you blame it all on women.
On our last
so
show,
women are Satan, basically.
He, you know, obviously we don't have all the evidence on this, so we can't.
We have enough.
Yeah, we
I'm
have. we have this. We have this thing that we showed on the last show. It was a comment where it looked like Stefan was trying to comment as someone else, but didn't realize he was using his own YouTube profile.
Oh, I saw that.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he was like, as an attractive woman, I feel this way.
I saw that.
This guy has a very, you know, the Vigilant Christian talks about people being confused about gender. I think Stefan Manure is actually confused about gender.
Maybe he wishes he was Stephanie.
Stephanie Manure. In fact, I'm going to call him that from now on.
Stephanie Manure.
That's Stephen Manure.
But if I do so much as put his name in the fucking title of the video, we get hundreds of fucking fanboys.
You sure
us.
They're not all of his like alternate accounts commenting?
You know, I would have said that was ridiculous before, but at this point, now that we've seen that he will go to that length,
yeah.
I wouldn't dismiss it.
You know,
I'm
it's
a very
hilarious.
Attractive female, and I love him. And everything he says is correct.
You know, hilariously enough, I was going through videos that people suggested for the show, and I. Every now and then I'll get fans suggesting guests to have on the show. You know what I saw today? Someone suggested that we have Dose of Buckley on as a guest. It's like, how long have you been watching our show? Yeah. So.
Stephanie Manure.
Stephanie Manure.
We are fundamentally programmed, particularly as men, to please women. And women, most women, they really like to spank. And spanking is more of a female problem than a male problem.
Why is it a problem?
And so to come out
I don't know.
It's not a problem at all.
It was like, why is it? He just makes like blanket statements. Like, it's a problem. No, it's not.
Hitting women is to serve the preferences of women. To come out against hitting children is to go against the preferences of women. And that's one of the reasons why it's so hard to change. Because anything which goes against the preferences of women is a very hard thing to change.
Okay.
You don't see a lot of organized boycotts against diamonds. There's a few, but not really that many, because women like magpies like the sparkly things for the majority.
So diamonds should be boycotted, and if they're not boycotted, then all women love diamonds.
Right.
Oh, it's just a recent phenomenon that was created by De Beers after the Second World War. This give a diamond ring. It's all bullshit. It's all just made up stuff because they had too many diamonds and industry wasn't using enough. So
they had to create this guy's been in too many bad relationships.
Oh, God. I feel I get that vibe every time I listen to him. I really do. I mean, like, everything I've ever heard him say, I just feel like, God, this guy has got, like, some intense bitterness issues going on.
Yeah, either his mom was a bitch or he was madly in love with some woman who was, like, a dom and was, like, wanted to control everything. And now he just thinks all women are like that. And
from what I understand, his mom was abusive to him.
I think also that, you know, because he's a woman inside, as those comments led us to believe.
It's all
know,
that toilet paper.
He's rebelling. It's the toilet paper. And he's rebelling against his internal self, you know?
Yep.
It all makes sense.
He's in denial.
Otherwise, people would be boycotting diamonds. It all makes sense, folks.
Bunch of nonsense about how a 2-month salary for something that lasts a lifetime. Philosophy lasts a lifetime. I don't demand 2-month salary from people. Be nice, but... So, protecting the rights of children is going...
I actually don't want a diamond on my wedding ring, like, or engagement ring or whatever. I actually don't care about diamonds. So he would hate me because I go against what he's saying.
Is there a stone you would prefer?
I really like lapis and emeralds and aquamarine.
Gravel.
Gravel.
I love hematite. Hematite's awesome, but I don't really care if they're like super expensive or not. I just like certain ones. I just don't care about diamonds. I never did.
Yeah, when I was in Amsterdam, I went to a place where they artificially grow diamonds out of like other diamonds. They take a little diamond and they grow like a giant.
Like
diamond
some like diamond it. Stem cell shit going
yeah,
on.
Yeah, basically, it's pretty crazy.
Desires of women. And, you know, it's a collective statement and there's exceptions and blah, 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 right? And this is one of the reasons why it's so hard. But it is going to be very tough to justify and defend as an adult when he is questioned by his children. It is going to be hard to justify and defend what he did, which went against all of the science and expert opinion
so wait a minute.
Of the time.
A caller called in and said that they're complaining about a father that spanks and hits children and Stephanie automatically goes on this tangent about how women want to hit children. It makes perfect sense.
That is, he's going to be in an indefensible position in 15 or 20 years. And that's something to be really cognizant of.
Who is it that actually puts these captions up on his video pointing out how full of shit he is?
I don't know.
Because it's very helpful. Ben doesn't know.
Ben
just steals
Ben's
from
not
people.
I am not.
You steal from people on the internet and then you fucking don't even know who they are.
All I know is that they should use a different font. That's all I know is that they should use a different font.
I don't even care. Like, I used to hate Comic Sans, but after listening to so many people whine about it, I'm actually supporting it.
Then you're just a hipster.
But it's better than Papyrus. I will say that.
I have some more questions. I think I've taken enough of your time, and that was helpful. Thank you very much.
It was not helpful.
You're very welcome. Thank you so much for calling in, and thank you so much for doing
even
what
I like how he cuts the sleeves off of his shirt like Patrick Coleman
to show off his muscular physique.
His muscles.
Yeah.
I am so macho. Look at me.
So, you know, every time we cover this guy... After the video post for a day or two, there's all these
Stephanie
in the comments section saying, TJ, you don't get it. You would like him if you listen to a video. It's like, how many of his videos have we listened to now? We don't like him. I mean, it's like, okay, what would I'm sure we'd agree with him on some things. I don't think there's anybody we would 100% disagree with on everything. So, but this guy's a piece of shit.
What I really hate about him is that he acts so certain of himself and that everything he says is 100% true and it is the way he says it is. And it's like he's in his own weird little world where that is a reality to him.
Yeah, and you'll notice that is a reoccurring theme with most of the people that end up on our show. Like Mario.
Yeah, I have a vigilant Christian.
Yeah.
Who's afraid to wipe his own ass. So, I think Mario. If he just eventually realized that Satan wasn't real, his life would be so much better.
Yes.
He wouldn't, you know, cry himself to sleep anymore, and he'd be able to wipe his ass freely and all these other things.
Wipe his ass freely.
Just whatever he wanted, you know?
This toilet paper turned me from Mario to Maria.
The next video is from Butt King.
Oh my God.
TJ. Now, the only reason the only reason is because he talks about you in the video.
Why are you doing this, Ben?
And he spews utter bullshit.
Oh my God.
And I just want you to.
Why are you doing this,
Please
Ben?
Please subscribe.
No! No one wants to subscribe to you, you fat, evil piece of shit!
He changed his intro. There's no more Final Countdown. I wonder if he got flagged for it.
Da-na-na-na.
Now we're gonna skip that. Yeah, okay, cool.
Yeah,
hello,
yeah,
ladies
and
gentlemen.
One cares
My
about
name
all
is
that.
Brett Keen from God TV Radio.
God TV Radio.
Make sure you up has always
is it
been
TV or is it radio?
Supernatural to the unknown. All of us, immediately, whenever we look at our
immediately
universe, we can see the appearance of design. Even non-believers point this out, even atheist scientists.
Eventually, he's going to get to you and talk about our show and how we're full of shit and everything. But
right.
But then they want to try to go down one of these philosophical rabbit holes in order to try to, you know, fudge it all up and say, well, if the universe was designed, then it could have been designed better. Well, sometimes we drive cars and we don't think a lot of them seem, but I discovered that he had to have like the atheist voice had that. I've been challenging a lot of non-believers out there on YouTube, and a lot of them seem very afraid.
All right, here it comes.
I've challenged
Shaking
Darren
in
Law.
My boots.
I've challenged the Atheist Voice. I've challenged Jacqueline Glenn.
Uh-huh.
I've challenged the Amazing Atheist. The Amazing Atheist had me on his show, and I did that. But I discovered that he had to have like four or five other individuals with him. He couldn't do it on his own.
You can't fight your own battles.
Hold on. Stop. That's the premise of the show. There's always like a few people on here. It's usually at least me and Ben.
Right, the hosts of the show.
Right. I mean, that's the whole thing of the show. And usually, like, not so much this month because of fucking his girlfriend, but usually Scotty's on here too. So there's usually like three people on the show just by default. And then sometimes we have a guest or something too. But there's no, it's not like, oh, we're afraid to face Brett Keen. I mean, and if anything, he's the one who does that because he's actually never come on the show by himself. He always brings a little posse of people. And then he never even fucking talks. He just fucking sits back while his little posse fucking talks.
Anyone who's new to the show, go back and watch the religion debate video on our channel. And you'll see that Brett just kind of randomly called us one day. And he had like three or four guys with him. And it was just me and TJ at first. And then we brought Paul's ego into the mix. And yeah, but let's play a little more. It gets even more ridiculous.
And I kind of let him get a pass on that because I realized that he's not smart enough to run the podcast and run the technical stuff all on his own.
Right.
But he also had suggested that when we talked, I asked him if he would be willing to actually debate me on my turf within one of my live hangouts.
There's no turf. This is the internet. This is YouTube. It's all the same
section
place.
Of the internet.
Right,
really,
right. Come to our side, the dark side of the tracks. Yeah, it's like,
well,
fuck
I mean,
you.
There is like the that turf. Part of YouTube, you know, the weird part of YouTube.
Oh, yeah, you got to watch your back.
At 4 a.m. and yeah.
It doesn't involve 10 people to operate a system in order to...
It doesn't involve 10... No. Brett, it's one person. It's one person
much.
Operating.
Yeah, Ben operates the technical aspects of the show. Pretty much 100%.
For it to work. The Amazing Atheist has still yet and refused to actually show up. have any kind of discussion or debate having to do with his own worldview. Apparently, he just wants to do his podcast where he gets drunk all day and insults people, and that's all he's got.
Yeah.
I love how he just makes these, like, definite statements. Like, 10 people drunk all day, you know?
He is the ultimate YouTube con man. Well, I guess he's not ultimate because he never really went anywhere with it. But
he's the ultimate exaggerator.
The funny thing about him is, like, he used to be an atheist, then he was a Christian, then he was an atheist. Now he's what he calls a theist because he won't take a particular position on theism. You know,
I almost never believe people who are currently Christians and say they used to be atheists. I think they're just trying to make it look like you can become a Christian after being an atheist. And I just find that difficult to believe.
But, well, I mean, in his case, there's some, you know, he actually did make atheist videos on YouTube for a long time.
Oh,
he's
really?
Actually,
okay.
He actually inspired TJ to start making videos. That's true. The odd part.
Well, then.
Yeah. But Brett, you know, I'm actually the one that banned you from our show, not TJ. Because you started, we were polite to you. We had you on our show. There actually is one instance where Brett came on by himself, and it was towards the end of a show. And we were cool with him. We actually treated him with respect, and even though we think he's full of shit, you know, we were nice to him. But I'm the one that banned you from the show, Brett, not TJ, and it has nothing to do with TJ not being able to run the technical aspects of the show. So if you want to come on, Brett, come on by yourself, and you and TJ can just talk, and I'll just mute my mic the whole time.
There you go.
And you guys can have at it.
That's a fair offer.
And you'll be like, well, why don't you do it on my channel? Well, Brett, we get 4,000 people watching our show.
Yeah.
And then 60 to 100,000 viewers after the video posts. Why would we want to go to your channel that'll probably end up getting, you know, suspended and terminated off of YouTube
it's
eventually.
It's a waste of time.
And you know, yeah, yeah, and
for your audience of like 200 people.
Exactly.
If that. I need to interject though. Ben, you and I have something in common, the small bladder thing.
Oh fuck. Yeah. So. I got to do it too, actually.
Oh, okay. We can do it together.
Oh. people already think I just proposed to you earlier.
Yeah, I know. I read that.
Yeah,
I read that.
So.
That's funny.
Anyway, we'll move on to the next thing, which will kind of kill time anyway while we take this break. So, yeah, Pistol, feel free to step away and do your thing.
Pistol.
Yeah.
Pistol.
Yeah. Pistol.
Yeah. So, apparently the Church of Gale was attacked by a sentient burrito and taco.
That happens.
Yeah.
It's like the crystalline entity, but with burrito instead of crystal.
We've got a bit of an emergency here. What happened is Bill Nye showed up and...
Bill Nye? Did you say Bill Nye showed up? Oh, my. Bill Nye, the science guy. Showed up. Is he an enemy of Gale's or is he one of Gale's allies? Let's find out.
He created a shield that covered Mexico and transformed the Pukaki into burritos and tacos. And it was feeding all the Mexican people.
Right.
And they were eating the burritos and...
Total logic right there, folks. Turned it into burritos and tacos. What's that? Is that a cat over there or is that a dog? I can't really see. I'm looking at a Pistol's window. Gale. The Church of Gale. A lot of people have become disciples of Gale since we started allowing her to preach her message here on the Drunken Peasants. So,
Tacos, and they tasted good, but it also created two giant, evil, sentient tacos and burritos. And they have started...
Okay, I'd like to remind everyone at this juncture that... This woman is apparently for real and has been stalking Brent Spiner for 22, 23 years. And she's literally sitting here talking about evil sentient burritos. So, yeah.
Eating the Mexicans and are attacking Church of Gale.
Oh, no.
Is she Gale?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, my God. I watched a video earlier that we can't even play on this fucking channel where...
Is the one where she gets naked?
She is partially naked in it. She reenacts something that happened to Brent Spiner, where she plays both Brent Spiner and like these aliens. And like Brent Spiner gets knocked out on a bed, and then this crazy alien with a giant penis, which is basically Gale with a giant dildo strapped to her stomach, comes in the room and like fucks Brent Spiner in the ass. And then later on, you see Gale as Brent Spiner with all this like fake blood coming out of her ass. It is crazy. This lady is a fucking nut job.
So long story short, she wants to peg him.
Yeah.
Long story short.
Yeah.
Gale knows what she's doing.
And he actually responded to her, and he looked very uncomfortable responding to it because he knows all about it. So
is trying to go do something like go through the sun or something. But we need more scientists.
Go through the sun. Try that, Gale.
The burrito. Is the burrito trying to go through the sun, or is the Church of Gale trying to go through the sun?
Neither of them can go through the sun.
How do you know what the Church of Gale's capable of?
I mean, you can go into it, but you won't come out the other side.
Right. Be vaporized way before.
You don't know. She might have some kind of multi-phasic shielding that...
Multi-phasic? Oh, you're just using Star Trek jibba-jabba right now.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah.
Bill Nye actually came up with the shield, but he thinks that the...
Bill Nye, the science guy.
He thinks that the Jesuits decalibrated his quantum subharmonic actuator.
Yeah.
And caused the shield to create this giant taco and burrito that's following Church of Gale right now trying to eat them. But at least they got it away from the four Mexicans, but it's hot on Church of Gale's trail. We need scientists. Email us at GaleCordSchuler@gmail.com.
Any scientists in the audience that want to help out?
If you're a scientist, please email GaleCordSchuler at that email address. Let her know that you are a scientist and you want to stop the transphasic burrito from destroying the Church of Gale. Please.
This is dire.
Yes, for the love of all humanity, Gale is sitting there in her shitty one-bedroom apartment.
That is
pleading.
A complete fucking mess, mind you.
I think we'll be underneath this video. The tacos are shooting at their communication array, so I may lose Terrance. I'm in the middle of a Skype with him. The shield turned the pukkake into tacos and burritos.
She said pukkake.
Well, then you can just eat the poo-poo, and then it's all taken care of.
Yeah, get some gays over there. They do that.
They'll clean it up.
But apparently the Jesuits sabotaged the shield, and so we scientists
try contacting Gale Cord.
What is happening?
I don't know.
She's a reptile.
Something happened.
She's a shapeshifter.
Burritos are coming.
This has happened a few times for no reason. The video will just start playing slow.
Has she ever acknowledged it, or just acted like
I don't know?
Happen?
But it's comedic gold. Here we go.
Schuler@gmail.com. And
we need some help. It's an emergency, okay? And also, Barack Obama, if you're listening to me, Church of Gale is being attacked by a giant sentient burrito and taco. So.
Yeah, Barack, you might want to appraise yourself of that situation.
Does she hear the shit that's coming out of her mouth, or
no?
Is it just like verbal diarrhea?
Basically. Oh my god, I have a backlog of this woman's videos, and there are videos where she is literally wearing a tinfoil hat in them.
Yeah, so I heard about that.
I always thought that was just, you know, I never thought that people actually wore tinfoil hats before.
Well, she does.
So now when I hear drinking the Kool-Aid,
to the point
I imagine
where you think like she has to be a troll, but yet she's so good at it that it's like, I don't know.
And she's been doing it before the internet. So if that's the case, then she's the world's first troll. I mean, she's been trolling
original
Brent
troll.
Spiner. Yeah, she's been trolling Brent Spiner for 22 years. It's like, what? I guess the internet did exist then, but it wasn't to the degree that it is now.
So. Why is this woman not in an asylum? That's what I want
to
know.
Well, the Church
of
Gale,
like, loose in the world.
The Church of Gale probably vaporizes anyone who tries to come commit her.
The thought of her operating a vehicle concerns me.
Yeah.
Well, she has a starship, so you better be really
worried.
Oh,
okay. Yeah, okay.
She has a starship, yet she lives
She's
in
never
a shitty
on
one
it, though.
Bedroom apartment.
She doesn't ride around in the Church of Gale for some reason. She just stays in her shitty apartment and talks to the Church of Gale via Skype. Perfectly sensible.
All right, so here's a clip about transgenderism in the news due to the tragic story of what was her name?
Lila Alcor.
Lila Alcor, yes.
Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and once again
it's Batman.
It's time for Ask Jason.
It's Ryback Man. He kind of looks like him.
He's not big
enough.
And
I came across an article yesterday that someone had linked on Facebook, and I wanted to talk about it a bit. And what I want to make
play a lot of videos where people are sitting next to cats.
Yeah, and I like the cats. I just despise the person in the video.
It's like you feel bad for the cat having to be with such a shitty person. I'm assuming this is a shitty guy, right?
You know, I don't know him personally, but his views in this video are pretty bad,
okay.
In my opinion.
Let's just take a look at that then.
I'm not saying that I'm right. I'm not saying my opinion is the only opinion. In fact, I know that's the opposite. I know that what I'm saying is currently contrary to what is being put forward by civil rights crusaders and by the mainstream media. But the thing is, what upsets me is that there is no dissenting voice allowed anymore in the media on this, on an issue that is contested. It is subject to debate, even in the mainstream psychiatric community. And I will link an article below interviewing a top psychologist and psychology researcher and psychiatrist who actually does agree with what I'm saying.
I think I know who he's talking
article
about.
I read.
When I was doing research, I think I came across the guy that he's probably linking to.
It's a tragic story of a transgender young man who felt that they were born in the wrong body and they were really a woman, whose very religious mother had, I think, had tried to put this individual through one of these guilt-based religious gender correction therapies to where they tell them this is evil is the devil, teaching them this and teach them that they're bad people for feeling this way, which certainly isn't the answer. That's doesn't work. It's not going to work.
At least he agrees with that much anyway. So he's not the worst possible position you could be on this.
Right.
At least. I could say that much.
Problems make things worse. And I think
but it's probably not much better.
People agree that approach is not going to work.
Uh-huh.
But this individual had killed himself.
No, Batman.
Why aren't we able to discuss the possibility that maybe this isn't a civil rights issue? Maybe it is a mental illness, as it meets all the criteria for a mental illness. And
okay,
it's not an illness.
You know, like, I mean, it was quantified as a mental illness
for
a long time.
So is homosexuality,
right? You know,
yeah.
You know, like the way that we approach stuff like this, and like anything to do with the brain is always going to be very complicated like that. And there's a lot of things that are described as mental illnesses that probably shouldn't be. And there's lots of things that, you know, like the DSM, I think they have something like 300, they have over 300 mental illnesses now. I think up like just 15 or 20 years ago, they only had like 130 or something like that. So we actually have been adding stuff to the mental illness list. But there's really no reason to consider transgender people mentally ill. There's nothing really wrong with the brains they have. I mean, well, there are mentally ill transgender people, but that's a separate issue.
Right.
Mm-hmm. There's no reason to consider them mentally ill just because there's nothing wrong with the brain except for it's in the wrong body. Really, they have a body problem, not a brain problem. So
that's not me saying it, and it's not the standard defense that people throw out there of, oh, you're just being ignorant, when there are people with PhDs and decades of experience in psychiatry who are saying the exact same thing. They're more qualified.
Okay, there's like As far as I know from my research, and I did do extensive research, there's one guy, probably the guy you're linking to down below, and I have found things that just shred him to pieces. But we're not going to make an argument from authority anyway. But I mean, here's the thing. Even if you're right and being transgender is a mental issue, even if we're going to grant that, the best known treatment for that mental issue is still transitioning to the gender that you identify with. That's still the best, most recognized way of solving that problem, and suicide rates in transgender people decline sharply once they've actually made a successful transition. So if you even if you do want to be ass backwards and view it as a mental health problem, you know, the best solution is still to let them transition to the gender that they feel they are. So just putting that out there.
You or I are. So if they're the ones who are saying it, and I'm reading what they're writing and saying, well, that makes a lot of sense what they say, then how is that ignorant? The people who aren't listening and realizing that there is a debate among psychiatrists on this still are the ignorant people. If you're not aware that this is a two-sided issue still...
This is kind of like... This is kind of dishonest. It's kind of the same way with, like, climate change or something, or evolution. You know, if you're a creationist or a climate change denier, you try to frame it like, the jury's still out. There's still a lot of people arguing about this. It's like... there's still a lot of normal people arguing about this. People, who, I mean, laymen, I should say. There's still a lot of laymen arguing about those things, but within the community of professionals that are actually charged with understanding and doing the research, there's not much argument. There's not a whole lot of biologists that are going to argue with evolution. There's not a lot of climatologists that are going to argue with climate change, man-made climate change. There's not a lot of people in with mental health expertise that are going to tell you that being transgender is a mental illness. You know, there's just not that big of a contention. There's not really that heated of a debate going on anymore.
He's also acting like it's a psychological thing when it's actually a biological thing. But he's right. Looking at psychological, I can't fucking speak right now. That's psychologists fair. That agree with him and completely ignoring the ones who don't as a way of promoting the way he feels about it. But it's
classic
it's actually
confirmation
a biological thing. Yeah, exactly. But it's purely biological, not psychological at all.
In psychology, then you're the ignorant one, not me.
Right.
I'm aware that this is
sure.
But it seems to me that why do we look at this differently than we would anything else? Why do we throw it even into the realm of gay and lesbian rights? It's a completely separate thing. Yes, that is sexuality related, but it's certainly not gender related, and it's not changing. It doesn't go towards changing, trying to change your biology, make permanent changes.
I feel like someone needs to like just overlay this. Like I want a picture of Batman just going like this while this guy's talking. Like, oh, don't
now,
wear my shirt.
Now we're gonna get a whole bunch of them.
Don't wear my shirt. Come on, fuck you.
All right. So you know what I think we pretty much said all we need to say about this video. Before we go on any further, please hit the like button to everyone who's watching this. Subscribe to our channel. It's youtube.com/drunkenpeasants. We got it back. It's working great. We're just not using it yet until we get partnered on a network because we want to prevent anything happening like the last occurrence. So, yeah. Anything else you want? Anything you want to say, TJ, before we move on?
Nope. Go ahead.
All right. Okay. So, Pat Robertson.
This is Karen Pat, who says we declined going to our daughter's house on Christmas this year because there's always an argument, hard feelings, etc. One grandchild comes high on marijuana, cursing and challenging our faith.
I correct him.
Yeah.
What is that?
I correct him and have told my daughter to ask him to respect our beliefs, but he keeps it up. Our daughter says she's a Christian, but will drink too and offend her daughter and her husband. Were we wrong not to attend another Christmas that leaves us upset or someone angry? I've shared my beliefs many times with them and am ridiculed by this grandson and son-in-law.
Yep.
Sounds like a good time to me. Invite me next year.
Somebody take that kid to the woodshed. And...
what?
Yeah.
Yep.
Take that kid to the woodshed, that little piece of shit.
But as Stephanie Manure let us know, that's only women that want to do that kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly,
so.
Yeah.
Pat Robertson must be Patricia Robertson. Patricia. You know.
Stephanie Manure.
Let him understand the blessings of discipline. He needs a strong male
blessings.
Figure. I don't know about his daddy, where the
so,
daddy is.
Basically, like, Pat Roberts is like, yeah, you need to fucking take him out to the woodshed, spank his little ass.
Spank
yeah.
that supple little ass.
Yeah, yeah. He needs to learn the pleasure of discipline.
If there's nothing
yeah.
wrong with it, then why do you have to hide in the woodshed?
Wow.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Well, the daughter is the child of this couple.
I dig it, but the kid's got a father someplace, and the father may be out of town, and the mother's not disciplined. He needs discipline. He's going to wind up in a correctional institution. The next thing you know, he's going to be doing hard time in some prison, and then he would wish he wasn't such a smart, you know.
Okay, so based on the fact that he, according to the person who wrote this letter, smokes marijuana and challenges religion, he's going to wind up in a penitentiary doing hard time. He's an evil criminal. And he needs to go to the woodshed and get his ass turned red and scarlet so he understands the fucking pleasure of discipline or whatever the fuck I said.
The pleasure.
I was that type of, like, I met that criteria just a few years ago. I'm not in jail, so he's wrong.
Yeah. You should have been taken to the woodshed, is all I can say.
Well, fortunately, we didn't have a woodshed. So.
Oh. All out in the open, then.
Wise guy, because he'll be disciplined in a way that he'll never forget in some prison. They'll prey on some young kid like that, but he needs discipline the worst possible
He's
way.
Literally referencing ass rape.
Christmas. Exactly.
Why ruin Christmas and let a lot of people like that get drunk and curse and abuse your Savior? Who needs that? You don't have to go.
You don't have to expose
yourself to this kind
sounds
of...
Sounds fun to me.
Just hold up your drink and yell, fuck.
Fuck Jesus!
I drank all night.
Ridicule and torment. I mean, it's supposed to be a day of rejoicing, so go where people want to rejoice in the Savior.
Savior sucks.
The Savior sucks.
People in our audience want to get spanked by Pat Robertson. They're like, spank me, Pat.
People
spank
are saying,
me.
Like, woo, Pat is kinky.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, fuck yeah, Pat. Take me out to the woodshed.
The problem is Pat's so old, I don't think he'd be able to do much. He'd be like, oh, now you're going to learn some discipline.
He'll learn this type of process. That was low.
Things explode. Everyone dies.
Okay, so this next video, which we won't cover all of, is entitled Atheism is a Mental Disorder.
Finally.
So, TJ, you need to be locked in a padded room.
Good.
All of us.
Yeah.
All
it's
of
fun
us.
Times. Freedom of speech.
Atheism is a mental disorder. It really is.
Right.
I mean, these people are messed up. It's,
yeah.
There's overwhelming evidence.
Overwhelming.
There's things we don't know.
Right.
There's overwhelming evidence of spirits. There's documentaries
spirits.
You can watch. There's kids crawling up the wall like a
AKA
snake. There's
personal experiences.
Famous hauntings. There's all kinds
evidence.
Of documentaries. There are ghost hunting shows.
Okay.
There are ghost hunting shows.
Ghost hunting shows that are utter bullshit.
Yeah.
Everyone
no,
I've
right?
ever watched.
There are Full ghost hunting shows that proof cannot be denied.
Irrefutable.
Ghost hunting shows, guys.
I loved watching Ghost Adventures because it's so funny to watch a guy wearing a shirt two sizes too small yell at the darkness, say, like, come at me, bro.
Come at me, bro.
I think that chair just moved.
Oh, my God.
Zoom I'm
going to
use this weird electronic device that proves that ghosts are here.
Yeah. There's like
a speck of dust. It's obviously a ghost.
There's like more electromagnetic waves here or something. So ghosts.
They get millions upon millions of viewers that are very famous, very popular, because other people have seen ghosts in their own lives.
Right.
There are literally 4.5 billion people in the world that believe in spirits because they've encountered them. And atheism is not that popular as they want you to believe.
I don't think... I don't think 4.5 billion people believe in ghosts.
Well, even if that was true, that doesn't make it... true, you know, just because the majority believes in it doesn't magically make it correct, you know?
Yeah, it does. Atheism's unpopular. Don't, what you talking about?
Because atheism's not popular, thus it's incorrect.
Anything, exactly. If you have unpopular beliefs, you're obviously mentally...
Reality is a democracy. You didn't know that?
Yeah, you get to vote on what's true.
Yep.
Sure, in France, 40% of people are atheists. That's the biggest number that they got. No other place.
I don't think I don't think France is the most atheistic country.
I think
it's
actually
Sweden? Like Norway.
I've actually looked this up. It's the Czech Republic.
Is it?
That's the most atheistic country on the planet.
Wow.
And I believe that's 80% or something like that. So that's way more than France.
It's equals 30%. Most places are 5-7%. But on the internet, it seems like they are extremely popular because they're not like Christianity and other religions. Older religions have broken off into so many different sects. Like, I've made a video...
Hold on. Broken off into what?
Sex. Not sex.
Broken off into sex. Sex, yeah.
Sex. Yeah, break off into some sex.
Shit, I left religion too
Apparently
young.
Apparently religions are just orgies.
Yep.
Well, Raelianism. Well, if anyone wants to look up Raelianism,
we know that
that's
Catholic
one religion.
Church is very into
it's all about orgies. Anyway,
sexual practices.
UFOs
and
orgies.
That later.
Raelianism. Yeah. The Raelians, they believe in UFOs and orgies, basically.
UFO orgies.
I know.
Against atheists and got 4,000 dislikes. You know, I got 4,000 dislikes from the video, but I only got a few likes because.
Hold on, wasn't he appealing to popularity just a few moments ago?
That's different though, because the internet is a different thing.
Oh, the internet's bullshit, right?
We're not real people.
Right.
No.
If you're on the internet, you're not a real person.
Right.
Internet's fake.
People in the older religions. Christianity and such are split into so many different factions that they can't agree on anything. If you want to make a popular Christian video, then you need to say something completely, just say, well, I love God. If you agree, hit like. Because if you say anything else,
I love God, hit like.
It's your.
We love God, hit like.
Like
hit
it,
like.
We love God.
Like hit, good. God, woo!
Hashtag we love God.
Yep.
Not going to get anywhere. Because there's so many different doctrines. Well, atheism isn't like that yet. They haven't split off in all these different factions, and they don't have that many friends usually, typically. I know some atheists. They don't do that much or have that many friends. Because most people believe in spirits, and atheists don't. And that does weigh on that.
I'm sorry, what does that have to do with anything? Atheists don't have friends, because, you know, most people... most people believe in spirits, but atheists don't, so they don't have as many friends. So, what?
Well, they don't have as many, like, spirit friends.
Right, like, if Casper the Friendly Ghost shows up, it's always the atheist who's like, get the fuck out of here!
Yeah, exactly.
...relationship a little bit. So, online, they found all their friends and they all agree with each other. So it's easy. An atheist makes a video, well, you got all the same subscribers. You know, it's not like the amazing atheist has this section of subscribers and then Mr. Repsian and other people... have this many subscribers, right? No, it's all the same people.
No, it actually is.
I know,
like
that's
that
fucking hilarious, because when we have Mr. Repsion on our show, we get tons of backlash.
Right, because we do not have exactly the same fan base. It's bullshit.
No.
And if you go, if you know, I've done shit with like the Bible Reloaded and Jacqueline Glenn and Dusty and all kinds of people, and I always see fans of theirs that are like, I can't believe you're working with that piece of shit, the amazing atheist.
Yep.
What a reprehensible scum fuck. Don't you know he's bad because X, Y, and Z?
We get that from, you know, I mean, that happens all the time.
Well, it's not that different when it comes all to, like, the technology channels and stuff. You know, I see that firsthand. You know, Tech Syndicate and Linus and Newegg and all those, they think we're like mortal enemies for some reason. And then they see us all hanging out in a video and they're like, oh my God.
Ah, since you bring that up, when I first posted this video, when our chat first started, they were all like, they're just shills for AMD.
Oh yeah. Oh, by the way, I paid Drunken Peasants $10 million.
Shh. Hey, Ben, you didn't tell me that. You just plan on keeping all that shit yourself? I want my $5 million.
AMD Circle R.
We don't have to tell Scotty, though.
No, not at all. Not at all. Scotty doesn't know. He's too busy.
Scotty doesn't know.
Yep. Yeah. But, yeah, AMD, awesome. Everyone get yourselves an AMD.
Yep. All AMD.
Better than Intel.
Even though Logan's computer is entirely Intel and NVIDIA.
Yeah.
It says mine's all AMD. But I'm not going to get into that. I'm not. I was going to. I was like, no, not happening.
Yeah.
Not here.
People intertwined. But they rule the internet because they don't have much to do, and they can easily agree with each other, even if they disagree with each other, because they agree with the point.
What?
But this isn't what I'm getting at. Getting at, it's a mental disorder. It's like a thousand people watching a wreck, and one person standing up and going, oh, it didn't happen. I know you guys are sitting there right now going, oh.
Again with the popularity. Yeah, you don't even want. Is this all he has?
I don't even understand what?
He's just rambling.
Okay. Well, alright, let's get a little deeper, I guess.
You don't want to listen, you know, because your stance is so fragile. Because if you had to believe that there was a God, then what would that say about you? So you've got this very fragile stance. But us, who have seen these things personally, and I don't mean some voice in our head. I mean, I've seen things where six people were involved at once that was impossible. I've seen things where three people were involved at once that was absolutely impossible, that defied anything
people
that you could test with your gadgets. And
all right.
That's what
hold on. I'm going to go back to one of the Hitchens arguments here. Where, you know, like, what is more likely, that this was the result of some sort of divine intervention, or that you're under a misapprehension of what actually happened? You're like, oh, this was impossible. You know, I've seen these things that are impossible. Like, first of all, your personal anecdotal experience carries no weight with anyone other than you. And second of all, even if you did see things that, according to you, were impossible, that doesn't mean, therefore, the Christian God is true. You know, because people of every spiritual faith, or of no spiritual faith at all, have seen things that they can't explain, or that are supposedly impossible.
The human brain is very susceptible to delusions.
Yeah.
And whatever we're not looking at directly, you know, when we like see things in the corner of our eyes, our peripheral vision, that's just basically calculations being made by our brain of what's there. And sometimes there's a miscalculation and we'll think we saw something that wasn't actually there.
Okay. And then also, like, I'd love to show this guy like a video by like Church of Gale and be like, okay, she's had all these personal experiences with Brent Spiner and the Starship. Known
She's
as the Church of Gale.
Shit.
No, but like, you know, according to him, how can he discount her? She's seen these things. So by that standard, it seems to me like he should be like, yeah, that must be real. There must really be a Church of Gale. Brent Spiner must really be married to this crazy fucking woman. Because she saw it. She had an experience.
Yeah.
Atheism is. It's like, these are the gadgets you're allowed to use. And if you can prove to me in this that what you're saying is true, then I'll believe it. But if you use the gadgets that other scientists make that can detect ghosts and such, nah, you can't use those.
There's no ghost detector. There's no ghost detector. There is no ghost detector.
It's called a PKE meter, dude. Come on.
Oh, yeah. I think this guy doesn't understand
that. Get your shit together.
Ghostbusters is not a documentary.
What? Fuck you.
It's real.
Hate you.
Slimer is real. Hashtag Slimer is real.
Slimer is my boyfriend.
Oh, yeah.
Use those because I don't trust those scientists. You're only allowed to use these scientists and the gadgets that I want you to use. It's a fact that God is not seen. Do you see God? I don't see God. So then if there is a God, he must be found.
Right.
And some of us have found God. But where was since he? You have not found God...
Where was he?
It's like, where's Waldo?
Yeah.
But he was behind the couch the whole time.
I expect you to believe in God because he doesn't love you and he didn't come to you. So you're not going to believe
everyone. Don't they say that he like loves everyone or some shit?
He loves them so much that if you fuck up, he'll throw you in hell for eternity.
Yeah. For God so loved the world that he sentenced them all to roast if they didn't love him back.
That's love, man.
Yep.
That's love.
That's how I love people.
That's what I do to all women that don't love me. I throw them in the fucking oven.
Ben's just like, you bitch. Love me or die, yep. Cunt!
Yep.
This is God's love! Taste the love of God, I think you we fucking move on. Whore! Burn!
Check this.
Burn!
We had a guy who made...
Ben.
What?
Burn! I'm ready to move on.
Okay. So we made a video response to a guy who used one of your videos talking shit.
This is going to get so confusing.
So this is a video response.
I know what you're about to play. I actually saw it a little bit earlier today, but this is going to be so fucking confusing to try to watch.
Here's the fucked up thing. Hold on. I'll wait till he gets to it, and then I'll bring it up. But he brings up the most... This just proves how dumb this guy is.
Okay.
All right.
I'm just saying this is going to be a very... People need to pay very close attention because it's literally going to be us... watching this guy play clips of our show of us playing his former video wherein he plays clips of an Amazing Atheist video.
Well, so if you're wearing like, different shirts, it's okay.
There's going to be like clips within clips within clips within clips here. So it's going to be kind of confusing, but we'll take a look.
Yeah, I just want to get probably like a few minutes into it just to address how stupid he is.
Okay.
For Ben. All right.
It's over.
Some guy talking shit about you, TJ.
Woo!
There's so many of these videos.
Well, that looks familiar.
Woo!
Good evening, YouTube. I am Torvald McDudebro. Now, obviously, when it comes to
hard-hitting
theology and deep, thought-provoking philosophy,
I'm Turd Breath McDudebro.
There's only one place to go.
You know,
I like bad religion.
But one of the interesting things is the idea that...
That was a weird cut.
Man, you atheists, you're just as bad as the religious people.
This is the Amazing Atheist.
The greatest YouTuber of all time.
Who has heard of this guy without having heard of you first, is what I want to know.
Yeah, yeah.
Like he needs to introduce who you are.
That's a good point, but I'm actually so humble that I never even thought of that.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Hipster Jesus!
They call you that, really?
Yep. I've also been called a hipster Viking.
Who's even saying this, by the way? Because if you're not religious and you're not an atheist, I mean, like, what else is there? Like, what group of people is even saying this? It's just these little assholes that go around calling themselves agnostic when they don't even know what the hell agnostic means. But still, there's this group of people that says, well, you're atheists are just as bad as the religious people.
I agree with this guy.
Yeah, that's a load of...
You agree with that guy that was just on the screen?
Yeah, yeah, that guy is cool.
Garbage.
Yeah, I don't like this guy.
Yeah, yeah. It's... And he's... He makes this crate of... I'll just play it more.
Less
here.
Of this guy, more of that guy.
Look at me. Does it look like I project my beliefs onto anyone at all? I mean, I swear to you... I do not follow any religious dogma. I swear on my copy of the God Delusion under the threat of eternal hit slaps that I do not dogmatically follow anyone who is an atheist. Ever. Ever.
And then there's okay. The religious people themselves who say things like, you atheists are always...
When you're on, it's all nice and clear, but when he comes back on, it's all crazy and, like, jumpy. And by the way, that's a recording of my voice, not my actual voice yet.
Yeah, I'm trying
what was
to, like,
that just
remind
went
myself.
Up their head? the joke. Anyway, TJ, what I'm trying to sit there and say is that many atheists, and your other two lackeys here, other atheists,
my lackeys,
will dogmatically follow people like TJ, Richard Dawkins, sorry, Christopher Hitchens, Sam Harris,
not dogmatically, it's because they agree with them.
Right. Yeah.
There's a difference.
Yeah.
These people agree with these other people, therefore it's dogmatic. It's like, actually, maybe there's like tangible reasons why. Maybe we just agree with their line of reasoning. You ever think of that, you fucking dipshit?
I mean, that's why I subscribed to you so long ago, is because I agreed with you.
Yeah.
Insert
I'm awesome.
Popular atheist
and I might worship you a little
and
bit.
And defend them no matter what. And defend what they say no matter what. No matter if it's bigoted, no matter if it's inaccurate. And to those that don't, often we are attacked, labeled as not hard atheists or not really atheist or whatever.
I've never heard of hard atheists.
Hard atheists.
It's like hard atheism. It's,
so does that
you
mean
know,
like soft atheist is a thing or...
It's some hardcore shit, you know.
The thing I don't understand is, you know, if you go to his channel, like, his videos average, like, 450, 500 views a video. So, I mean, like, I really feel like what he's really saying here is, they dogmatically follow all these atheists. Why doesn't anyone dogmatically follow me?
Yeah, he's just jealous. He's envious, not jealous, but yeah, he's envious.
He's envious of my hard atheism.
Term you wish to use there. And so I'm saying that they often act religious. I've actually made serious video series on this topic. I don't expect you to watch them because that actually involves, you know, you thinking, and that doesn't seem to be something you're very capable of. However,
ooh, shots fired.
Yeah. I made this video series that I don't think I'll watch because you can't think, and that requires thinking.
If you don't watch me, you're stupid.
Basically, you missed the point of the joke.
Yeah.
Instead, you're going to attack the aesthetic qualities of my video because you have nothing else.
Hold on.
We didn't really miss the joke. We got the joke. First of all, it just wasn't funny, and the point was stupid, and there was like, you notice we didn't even comment on it at all, one way or the other. The only thing we had to say about that portion of your video was just that your fucking audio quality sucks, because that's about all that really was warranted at that point, because your point was just so stupid and oblique and nonsensical, and your joke just fell so flat that it wasn't even worth our time to sit there and, like, deconstruct it and try to figure it out. Like, you're mistaking it for, like, I made this really brilliant point and you guys are too scared to address. No, that's not what happened. What happened was, you're an idiot and we actually gave you a pass and just let that slide because we were trying to get to a more substantial idiocy than that one. So,
I don't know.
Trying to shove your atheism down everyone's throat. Atheists are so forceful. Atheists are always trying to... Atheists always think they're right, and they're always trying to make, you know, you shout with their big megaphones, and like, we're right, and there is no God, and no one's allowed to believe in God.
I actually have something to say in regards to what TJ is saying in that clip, is I actually had to put a sign on my door the other day saying to, like, not come to my door and preach Christianity because we're atheists.
Wow.
I had to put a sign up because it's like a Saturday thing to go around.
I have a similar sign on
right,
my door, actually.
He does.
It actually tells people, I don't want to listen to your political views. I don't want to listen to your religious views. I don't want to buy anything at the door. I don't want to buy new home insurance or change my utilities or listen to anything you have to say. Please, no uninvited person should be knocking on this door at any time.
But how many people do you know of who have signs that say, don't tell me about atheism? I don't know anyone.
It's not necessary. Right. Atheists aren't going door to door.
Exactly.
Right.
That's the point.
Handing out blank pamphlets.
Coming up here in the video.
Read this Bible, there's nothing in it.
I make a comment here that this guy takes totally wrong. This guy doesn't flag us for using his video. So I say, I hope this guy doesn't flag us for using his video. What I meant, I said it sarcastically as in, this guy's using TJ's video and we're reusing a video that he used of TJ's. I hope he doesn't flag us.
And talking about me.
Right.
So if anything, you'll get flagged for the thumb.
Right. And he the fucking hilarious thing is that he takes that comment seriously and is like, you're lucky I don't flag you.
You're so lucky.
Now, see, has a I could sit there and say that you're not informing of me using a content, my content.
It's really funny because he actually, he accuses us of not getting his joke, but he's actually the one that missed your obvious joke.
Are you not gracious, sir, for not flagging us for using a video of TJ's in your own video? That
I think it's pretty funny. He's like, he's just, it is. It's like Inception almost. It's getting fucked.
We didn't get copyright permission to use the video you made with TJ's content in it.
It's like Video Centipede, really.
Right.
And then put ads all over it. I'm not pleased about that, but I'm not going to go out and flag your video because I have more important things.
His butt hurt. I can smell it from here.
You can smell his butt hurt.
Smell the butt hurt. That must not smell very nice.
It doesn't. It doesn't. It smells like he's afraid of BPA.
To get the, you know, couple of pennies I'd ultimately gain out of that. Not really interested in making money off YouTube. This is a hobby.
Well, that's good, because you only get like 400 views a video, so you wouldn't be able
to. If he were to get enough viewers to actually make money, he...
Oh, yeah, he'd do it.
His tone would change so quickly.
He'd do it in a fucking second.
I know.
And that's mainly as far as I wanted to go in his video, because the rest of his video is garbage. I just think it's funny that he was like, yeah, I could have done it, but it's not worth it. It's like, dude, we took the only reason we even played your shitty video is because you used TJ's video in it. So
I'm sure most of his views are because of you guys.
Acting like you're taking the high road by not flagging us for playing the video that you could have been flagged for is absolutely ridiculous.
You probably did flag it, but then nothing happened. So he had to revert to this statement. Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Next, I'm going to play one of the videos you sent me, Pistol, of the false prophet. Yeah. So this woman runs some kind of church, some kind of revival somewhere.
She's like a miracle healer. One of those.
I see. And she invited some other pastor on stage with her, thinking that he would totally be on her side.
And I guess he's not, from the way you're talking.
It's interesting what happens here.
Thank you tonight. I appreciate you very, very much. God bless you. You wanted to say something?
To the Calvary Chapel. Hey, you guys know me as the few that are here from Calvary Chapel as Pastor Scott. It's good
what
to
I
see
love
a few
about
of you
this video
here,
is that she's just
and
nodding
then a few of you
like
in the back and over on the side.
He's right. He's Christian,
she
so
just
he's
nods.
Also right.
He just starts talking, and she's just nodding. He hasn't even finished a statement yet, and she's just nodding.
Like, yep, I agree with whatever he's about to say. Yep.
I just wanted to say that, yes, I did talk with her last night, and I didn't know much about her ministry. She was kind enough to give me as many materials as she could on the spot, and her men were perfect gentlemen to me inside. And for the rest of these seven...
What? Hold on, what?
What?
What did he just say?
Her men? Something about her
they
men.
They were perfect gentlemen on the inside.
On the inside.
Yeah.
On the inside. He was getting inside her men's.
7 days that she's here, any of you that come and any of our friends that come, we need to be deeply respectful. We need to show an intense love to them. But above all of those things, we need to spend all of our time at the deepest place of prayer, praying that God indeed would protect all those who hear this false message that comes from her lips. Because
you see, now she's looking at him.
Like, what?
I love how he takes so long to build up to it, you know?
It's like, this false message that comes from her lips. And then she's like, what the hell? But she's still holding the mic, so I'm assuming she's going to try to take it away.
God's message is not miracles, but that the shed blood of Jesus Christ would cleanse humble sinners. And when miracles are emphasized, Jesus is denied.
She like ripped it away.
Okay, guess what? Go, I didn't say it, they did.
There's a Jesus riot going on.
You all heard the words that he spoke, and his blood is upon his hands, not mine. So we thank you, Father God, in Jesus' name. You are rebuked. You are removed from my tent. And
in Jesus' name, I'm telling you what to do.
Yeah. Where's Jesus to like come and actually back that up?
I don't feel like, I feel like her she's like overreacting. I mean, I know that sounds strange because obviously she's like psychotic and he's not even much better anyway.
Well, he's basically just calling bullshit on her stage. You know,
right.
Saying that she's a liar and stuff like that.
But I mean, like, if she was a true Christian, or, you know, she had the spirit of Christianity, I mean, like, wouldn't she be like, well, you know, you're my brother anyway, and da da da, and, you know, have a more conciliatory attitude rather than just being like, your blood is on your hands for daring to believe in Jesus a different way than I do. Get gone from my tent, sinner. I mean, it's kind of
believe in miracles. That's not. You will need a miracle one day. Get this on film, because he'll need a miracle one day. And when he needs it, he'll know not to come to my church. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. No, 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 no.
No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no.
I guess they're actually trying to like assault him at this point, and she's kind of like,
well, they're like yelling in his face and shit because they all agree with her because this is, you know, her church.
Miracles. Do you notice and recognize
miracles? But I mean, according to the Bible, shouldn't women not preach? But yet,
fucking,
that's what she does.
I have one response to that. Fucking magnets. How do they work?
No, no, no. Don't touch him. Don't touch him. Don't touch him.
He's a sinner.
Please be removed from my tent. Please be removed from my tent. Okay, please get out of my tent. Sir, please get out. It's not me, but it's the people that...
Oh, no, it's not her. It's
yeah,
the
people. Yeah, exactly. Even though she said it before they even started getting in his face.
Yeah, it's the people. It's not me, it's the people. It's kind of funny for her to blame her congregation while they're sitting right there. Like, it's not me, it's these fucking psychos in my audience. Get gone, loser.
In Jesus' name.
All right, so that's
beautiful.
I just love how it's, you know, two Christians, and yet they have different viewpoints and have a conflict.
Not even substantially different either.
No.
They're arguing about their imaginary friend.
I think he wears a red hat. Bullshit, it's blue. Be gone.
Yeah, let's see. I'm trying to find out what we'll play next here. Oh, we had a shooting at our airport today. Here's a news story about that.
At your airport?
Yeah, here where we live.
Ben's personal airport.
Yes, my personal airport.
Damn,
just outside.
Rich.
Yeah. Shh. Can't let the ladies
know. It's all that
money
I gave you.
Yeah, thank you.
Ben great. International Airport.
Yep. Now, Columbus Airport, which is not international.
Whatever.
About 1 p.m. this afternoon, our officers with the Columbus Regional Airport Authority were called to respond to a disturbance on this level, the departure level at Port Columbus International Airport on the north side, so immediately behind me. There was a confrontation with the police officers as they responded to the call to respond.
So there was a confrontation, which means the officers were clearly justified.
Confrontation. Yeah.
Through that confrontation, the person who was causing the confrontation was shot and killed by CRA police officers. Police officer.
Why does this guy seem so nervous?
He keeps like looking around.
Yeah, he's like
very shifty. And
maybe there's more killers about. He's just scared.
Maybe he's afraid of the cops shooting him.
Like, I say the wrong thing, this cop. To the side of me is going to blow my brains out right here on camera.
The situation was contained to the departure level, north curb, again, this level behind me. And therefore, it enabled us to keep the facility open by using the arrivals drive. So our flights are coming and going using the arrivals drive. I will indicate to you that there was a vehicle involved with the
individual to us.
Who was causing the disturbance, and that the Columbus Bob Squad is currently going through that vehicle.
Is this guy some kind of spokesman? Because he really isn't doing his job well. He
no,
seems
he's like,
extremely
there was a. We were going to indicate that there is an individual who facilitated the
We're Columbus Bomb Squad is searching his vehicle.
If that was me and I was, you know, completely sober and there were numerous news channels sticking microphones in my face and cameras everywhere, I'd probably be pretty nervous too.
Presumably, though, like, this is part of his job, is to talk about this issue or, you know, things like this when they happen. Otherwise, why is he doing it? I mean,
right.
Okay, he's afraid of getting shot.
And it's not like shootings never happen here. I mean, so I don't know.
Yeah.
To understand what it may or may not have inside.
Right.
And by the way, to anyone who's wondering why we haven't covered the France shooting, TJ made a video about it, and we've decided that we'll comment on that as the story progresses here on the show, and maybe.
But watch my video in the meantime.
Right.
Go watch it. It's on this channel, The Amazing Atheist.
Yes.
Go watch it.
Watch it or die.
Watch it or die.
Watch it or burn.
You'll get airborne herpes if you don't watch that shit.
Burn!
We biologically engineer airborne herpes in TJ's basement, which is also where he sleeps, ironically.
Airborne
enough.
Ebola.
Herpades.
Gonoherpesyphilades.
Yeah.
You'll get it all. All right, so next one is the law in Oklahoma that they're trying to pass banning hoodies. Have you heard about this?
Oh, no. I heard about that, yeah.
Yeah.
I have like 90
They're
hoodies.
They're a common closet find. The hood.
Me too. I have all kinds of fucking hoodies.
Ben
so.
Is literally wearing a hoodie
wear
right
wear
now.
The hood. I just don't like wearing things that don't have a hood, but I don't really use the hood.
Well, then that's pointless.
I have long hair.
So
but
do
ben,
I.
Ben is literally
hood.
Ben is we literally all... wearing a hoodie right now. So if we were in Oklahoma, Ben could be arrested and killed.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, like, long hair is covers the same amount that a hoodie does. You know, if you
I don't like
the
to
hood
get my hair wet, sweetie. Come on.
I remember I went to the bank once and I had like a beanie on or something because it was the dead of winter in Massachusetts and they're like, you have to take that off. And I was like, I'm coming in here for 2 seconds. Like, what the hell?
Yeah.
Trying to rob the bank, huh?
Obviously. And I had like a deposit like written out and everything. I handed it to them and they're like, you have to take your beanie off. Like, pretty sure I wouldn't go to this extent if I was going to rob you.
Right.
Hoodie.
I've been wearing hoodies ever since I was a little kid.
Even Kevin Durant is a hoodie fan.
Somebody is out.
Everyone
running,
wears hoodies.
Especially in this kind of weather. Where
except
it's
for that guy.
Drizzly, I mean, you might be inclined to wear your hoodie while you're at Lake Hefner.
There are already laws in Oklahoma preventing hoodies during a crime.
21 OS 1301.
Why don't they ban ski masks? Wear,
I have a question.
A hoodie or some sort of...
why do you need to ban a specific article of clothing during a crime? Isn't the crime itself already illegal? I mean, like... If you're
obviously
a criminal,
it's not illegal enough.
But I mean, like, if you're a criminal, you're not going to be like, hey, I'm not allowed to wear a hoodie while I'm robbing people, you know? It's like...
I think it's just kind of their way of getting away with profiling people. So then if they make hoodies illegal, then if they see you wearing a hoodie, they can just profile you and be like, oh, you're wearing a hoodie, you're up to no good, you know? And then they have every right to do that because then it's illegal in that state.
Yeah.
Of disguise during the commission of a criminal offense.
Now, a proposal for an amendment to that law could make it illegal.
He was also wearing shoes when he did that. Banned shoes.
What a fucking asshole.
To hide your identity in public, the fine for your fashion crime, $500.
Call the fashion police.
Wow, I never thought about that.
They are literally the fashion police.
Literal fashion police.
Oh my god.
It's kind of magical.
It like just struck me. Oh man.
As long as it doesn't, you know, violate
criminal.
The realm of
yeah.
criminal
murderer right there
and
standing
I
in the cold.
I think that this could be very problematic.
Senator Don Barrington authored the amendment. He told us they want to help victims.
Senator
of
Don
robbers.
Barrington is a fucking
quote,
moron.
Oklahoma businesses want
criminals
state
wear
leaders
gloves.
To be...
Well, they yeah. gloves. They wear socks within their shoes.
If let's you just ban it, criminals won't find.
Let's just
ban all clothes.
Ban all clothing. Oklahoma is a fucking nudist state now.
Yeah, everyone has to be naked.
Anyone who's caught wearing any clothes will be presumed a criminal and
I
shot
dead. I know where
dead.
I'm taking my next vacation. And I'm packing light this time.
So according to my standards, Oklahoma would be high as shit, and I would not want to wear clothes. So.
What if you're driving through Oklahoma, but you have a hoodie?
You're a fucking criminal.
Yep.
Should you take
you're
it off? Like when you reach the state line, should you stop your car and take off your hoodie? Because like,
no,
you
just
know.
Take it off while you're driving.
Yeah.
be responsive to their safety concerns, and this is one way we can provide protection.
I think that the
I feel so protected by this ridiculous law.
Safer, but in doing so, I think they just overreached a little bit.
They might
a little bit.
Issues for keeping them on. Maybe they're having a bad hair day, or maybe they have cancer and they're losing their hair. I mean, you just don't know why.
I don't think that solution.
He's wearing a fucking hoodie.
I don't agree with that solution because it's retarded.
I just put my hood up. Like, fuck this.
It will work. I just think that will cause a little bit more tension within the community. It probably will be a reason.
I love how they're
jeans,
just,
you know.
Yeah, hoodies are evil. Anyone who wears a hoodie is probably trying to commit crimes.
They're
crimes,
and you know, the satanic hoodie makes you want to commit.
You know who else? You know who else wore hoods? The Druids.
I would say Hitler too. Even though I have no evidence, I would say Hitler.
Hitler.
You just feel that way. So it
I don't have facts to back this up.
And because I do this every show, I'm gonna. I came up with a band name when Ben said that. Hitler in a hoodie.
Hitler in a hoodie.
That could be a band name.
Or Hitler's hoodie.
Yeah, that works too.
I think we'll move on.
I still like Synagogue of Satan, though. That's yeah. Still my favorite.
Synagogue of Satan!
I'm going to play this next story. You can give me your honest opinion on what you think really happened if you take the story at face value or if you think maybe something else went on.
I'm the chief of police. It's the gun is on the dresser.
Okay. I like how he opens this 911 call with, "I'm the chief of police." The gun is on the dresser.
He's just saying random shit.
Yep. But he really is the chief of police. That's the funny part. But I like how he opens with that.
Yeah, okay. You're the chief of police in Peachtree City?
Yeah, unfortunately, yes.
unfortunately for him or unfortunately for Peachtree City?
I'm guessing more so, yeah.
That's Peachtree City Police Chief William McCollum in an early morning 911 call New Year's Day telling the operator he just accidentally shot his wife Margaret as the couple laid in bed.
What?
Yeah.
Oops, I did it again.
Either he's trigger happy and they got into an argument, or they were doing some kinky shit and he accidentally pulled the trigger.
Shoot me, bitch. Shoot me.
He said it was an accident.
Yes.
She was shot twice, accidental?
Twice? Okay.
What?
That is not an accident. I don't care who you are. You don't accidentally shoot someone twice.
Bang! Oops! Bang! Oops!
I'll sing this. You know, sometimes me and TJ do finish each other's sentences.
Huh.
Yeah.
I'll say something and then TJ's about to open his mouth and I'll put my finger of his mouth and I'll be like, shh, there's no need to even say it.
It's so cute.
Yeah.
Who shot her?
I shipped
me.
How did you shoot her?
The gun was in the bed. I went to move it, put it to the side, and it went off.
Hold on. Wait.
It doesn't just go off. You have to pull the fucking trigger.
Right.
Safety has to be off.
Why would you
not have the safety on?
If guns were really, like, that touchy that they just, like, go off all the time as you're just touching them, even if you're, like, a trained police officer, then no one would be able to make the argument that we should have guns or a right to bear arms if it was that fucking, like, if they were that unreliable. Like, I brushed up against the gun and it fired several times and killed some orphans.
Yeah.
But later in the call, just as first responders arrived...
Right. We'll probably cover it on a future show here, but someone sent me a video of some cop. He's in an elevator and he's off duty, but he has his
gun.
And
he hits on Rebecca Watson.
That would have been even better, but no, he accidentally shoots himself in the groin in the video. Yeah. Yeah. These people are supposed to be
I think they just like fondle the trigger because it makes them feel like they have power.
Like it's a little
bit. They get on these like power trips.
Oh, yeah, stroking my trigger, baby. Fuck
yeah. Yeah. And then they pull it, they're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
If it sounds like McCollum may contradict himself, telling the operator he was asleep when the gun went off.
Yeah, I got the door open for him. Oh, my God.
What's your name, sir?
How did this happen? Will McCollum?
You pulled the trigger, that's how it happened.
Were you asleep also, sir?
What did you say?
That's how it happened. I said, you pulled the trigger, that's how it happened.
Yeah, I don't know. And then,
how did this
and,
happen? I don't know. You pointed it at her and you pulled the fucking trigger.
And here they ask, like, were you asleep when it happened?
It happened.
Yep.
I sleep shoot people all the time.
Earlier if he was asleep, how did he know?
Earlier he said that he was, like, reaching to move it.
Right.
So, I mean, like, it doesn't even make sense.
They're already trying to, like, defend him and
right.
make up an alibi.
He was just protecting people.
Sherry Lang, whether that was a red flag for agents investigating the case.
It has been taken into evidence. But the call speaks for itself, and we'll conduct the investigation and determine exactly what did occur that morning.
Oh, so
but so far, Lang says McCollum is...
Yeah.
So basically nothing.
Right.
Like
paid vacation. This guy shot his wife. He deserves a paid vacation.
We're sending him to Bermuda.
I'm so sick of these paid vacations. It, like, gives them incentive to do shit like this, you know?
Hey, wait.
Like,
wait.
Hey, I want some time off, but I still want to be paid for it. I'm going to shoot my fucking wife.
These guys are putting their lives on the line every day to protect us. How dare you say that?
Yeah.
He's not facing any charges.
I don't feel protected if they're going to potentially put me in a chokehold for 8 minutes until I die.
Ben, do you want to move on to questions? Because I think I'm leaving in like 20 minutes.
Okay.
Or how many do we have? Do we have enough to last us 20 minutes?
Let's see. Probably not, but I have like one more story.
All right, let's just do that then.
All right. Let's see.
Time now for the ridiculous. And tonight we have a story of a certain kind of fun, wholesome entertainment.
You know who
hates
Anderson Cooper is Galen.
Galen hates a lot of people.
Yeah, but Galen like passionately hates Anderson Cooper and like had. I remember one time Galen wrote this like giant argument about why Anderson Cooper was a piece of shit. And I think it was about 2 years ago. And he was like, I'm going to make this video against Anderson Cooper. And he never actually made it, but. I never understood his argument because he would come to me with it and he would talk to me for like 45 minutes and I'd be like, I have no idea what the fuck he's talking about.
And then he's
about.
Like, here's my pre-closing statement before my actual closing statement.
Yeah.
He doesn't remember the joys of Play-Doh. Over the years, there have been all sorts of new and exciting things.
Oh, this is the Play-Doh dick.
Take, for instance, the new Play-Doh Sweet Mountain Cake Shop playset. Comes with a cake stand, plates, different colors of Play-Doh, and all sorts of fun stuff. So why, you may ask, would we be talking about this on The Ridiculous?
Because it comes with a dick.
I wonder,
the Play-Doh dick.
I wonder if Anderson Cooper like realized this on his own.
Nah. Anderson Cooper is like looking for dick everywhere.
Right.
That kind of looks like a dick. That kind of looks like a dick.
Well, it seems some people were outraged when they saw one particular part of this Play-Doh set called the extruding tool, which is used for making designs.
Extruding tool.
Dick designs.
You know, it's funny because we covered a story with Anderson Cooper where he talked about this giant vagina sculpture where this kid like got his head stuck inside of it, and he could not even say the word vagina.
He was scared.
And I mean, like, it's perfectly
so
acceptable
giggly.
To say.
He was a scared.
And he was like, it looks like a gina. Gina was all he could say.
he would say va like under his breath. Like,
Gina.
Gina.
Vagina.
Looks like a big gina.
Vagina.
If anything, I mean, yeah, it kind of looks like a dick, but it also kind of just looks like a syringe type apparatus, I guess you could say.
It's supposed to be to make designs with the cake surface on the Play-Doh.
That is the perfect like, design.
I forget the word for it. Those fucking, like if you put the frosting in like a bag and you cut the corner off. And
yeah.
We all know what you're talking about,
well,
but I have no
idea
what
this
called.
Before, and we're only going to show it once, so pay attention. There
Ooh.
It is.
There it is.
Ooh, it looks kind of like a dick.
I have that exact spiral design going around my dick. Seriously.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Ben's got a strange dick.
Yep.
Ribbed for her pleasure.
It is.
Yeah, people have told stories about Ben's dick.
They sing fables about it. It's almost like Klingon battle songs about
like
Ben's
Klingon
dick.
Klingon opera.
Yes.
Ben's dick!
I think adults tend to forget that children don't really look at things the same way that adults do. Their brains aren't tainted yet. So.
Right.
Bullshit. Any kid that looks at that is like, Mommy, why is there a dick?
That's the extruding tool. People actually started writing things online about how this had ruined Christmas. Let's just say the company took a lot of ribbing and was forced...
A lot of ribbing!
We get it, Anderson. We fucking get it.
All right, fuck you, Anderson Cooper. Let's just go on to fucking questions. Why not? All right,
piping.
Here we go.
Yes, that's the word. The chat got it. Piping.
Whatever.
Hey, guys. Ben, TJ, Scotty, if you're there, you lazy little fuck.
Yeah, my I like that.
This girl always draws women with huge tits.
Yeah. And
sends looks like she's drawing a dragon.
You right today now.
It'll have tits.
Your life
okay.
Was a
it's got a big ass.
Yeah, it's got a big ass on it.
Story in a
true
book.
What's a bat?
And you were the author.
It's like a,
how would you write
a
it?
A bat with
so
a human ass.
It could be any genre, basically.
She's a furry.
Yeah.
Confirmed.
Would you fuck
would
that
you
bat's
your
ass,
environment?
Ben?
And also, how would you describe yourself as the main character? It can be anything you want.
Did we even hear the question?
I don't think so.
I didn't.
We were too distracted by the bats.
I know. Hold on. We'll play it one more time.
Hey, guys. Ben, TJ.
Look at that bat's ass, guys.
Scotty, if you're there, you lazy little fuck. My question for you today is, if your life was a fictional story in a book and you were the author, how would you write it? So it could be any genre. Basically, how would you describe your environment? And also, how would you describe yourself as the main character? It can be anything you want.
So there's basically like godlike powers.
Yeah, I don't even know how to answer it, honestly.
You know, like there would be so much detail to go into. Like, you know, obviously anyone would just use that for wish fulfillment. You know, like everything you want, you just have. I mean, I guess it's supposed to reveal something about your character as you sit there and fucking talk about, you know, I would do this and I would do that, but, like, there's just really too much to go into, and, like, you'd almost have to sit there and contemplate this for a while to figure out exactly how you'd set everything up.
Any thoughts?
It's very lengthy.
Yeah.
Like, just like he said, you would have to think about it for a while, and then even if you came up with an answer, the answer would be, like, an hour long.
Right. Okay.
And it would have lots of tits and explosions.
Tits and explosions.
And badass.
And blackberry jam in the cleavage, apparently. And,
it
and,
looks like blueberry.
Oh, blueberry, yes. With,
she's eating a blueberry pie with whipped cream.
With whipped yes cream.
But she's not very good at eating it, because it looks like yeah more is getting on her tits than her mouth.
Yeah. She doesn't you're know where her mouth is.
You're supposed to eat it.
She blueberry pie, blueberry pie,
so much
blueberry
air in her
pie.
Head. She's like, I don't know where my mouth is. Put it on my tits.
Duh.
Hey, what's up, drunken peasants? I'll get straight to the point. Recently, when Marilyn Manson posted that Vigilant Christian video to his social media and stuff, I noticed there were a lot of comments in there that were like, oh, you know, this guy's a fucking retard. He doesn't speak for us. He makes us look bad. And things like, well, you know, I am a Christian, and I listen to Marilyn Manson, or, you know, whatever. I thought that that was kind of cognitively dissonant, you know, listening to Manson being a Christian at the same time. I just wanted to see if you had any further thoughts on that, if you just think I'm being an asshole. Smoke pan every day.
Okay, well, first of all, yes, we think you're being an asshole, but...
I mean, the thing is, it's like, I don't think that you have to necessarily, like, I don't think you have to necessarily, like, agree with Manson's positions on something to listen to his music. I mean, you can just enjoy whatever you want to enjoy regardless of what your beliefs are. But if someone was like a hardcore Manson fan, I think it would be pretty strange if they were also a Christian, because it's kind of antithetical to the spirit of the music. But, you know, obviously some people have found ways to reconcile that. But I guess I don't really care.
Yeah. Same here. Don't care. And move on to the next one.
Hello, Drunken Peasants Podcast. As TJ in the past has said, he doesn't really watch YouTube videos, so this is more of a question for Ben and Scotty, assuming he's not too busy
yeah
plowing
fuck
the
you,
northern.
TJ.
Yeah, fuck you.
Tonight, the part of Scotty will be played by Pistol. So.
Yeah.
Oh, God, I'm Scotty now? Okay. I'll dismiss it like this, then.
I, like about 20% of all YouTubers, I would say, used to do video game reviews until about last October when I said on my channel that I would no longer be doing reviews. I fully intended to move on to other content, but that did not happen. So, should I go back on my word as what a goddamn dirty liar, and step back into the reviews and get them started up again, or should I push forward out of my own comfort zone? And if so, from what kind of content would YouTube most benefit?
Wow.
Video game reviews on YouTube, it's so oversaturated by just everyone does it, you know? And so you being noticed out of the sea of everyone else who does it is next to impossible. So the best way to try to get noticed on YouTube currently is to do something that no one else is really doing, instead of doing what everyone else is doing. Because
I think you should
he
should review microwave TV dinners.
Yeah,
seriously,
I have not seen
like
anyone
that
do that.
I kind of feel like
someone who can't make this sort of decision on their own would even make interesting videos on any subject matter anyway. You know, I don't know. I don't mean to be like mean or anything, but it's if you can't figure out what kind of content you want to make, why the fuck should anyone else care about it?
To cut to the chase, do you guys think that mainstream music today is pussified? And if so, do you think that should grow some balls again?
Yep. Peace.
You know,
when did mainstream music really have balls? I mean,
right.
Everything that I've ever liked that I've considered to have balls has not really been very popular on the radio or ever played on the radio.
I don't agree with that.
I would say during the 60s.
I would say during the 60s and like the 90s as well. I would say the grunge stuff was pretty like
grunge, yeah.
It was dark and it wasn't, I mean, it was willing to like explore darker terrain of the human psyche and shit. But I feel like even in like the 60s, even in like the 70s and 80s, and maybe even in the 50s to an extent, or I mean like, you know, I mean, once like jazz was the popular music and that was, you know, despised and hated by a lot of America because it was kind of pushing towards a post-racial America or actually like, you know, a new art form that was being pioneered by a group of people that a lot of people supposed to be an inferior race. You know, there's a lot of exciting things happening in music, maybe not always in the most mainstream music, but there was always at least something going on, an undercurrent of something that was new and innovative and interesting and exciting. And I feel like that's been the case throughout the history of popular music until very recently, when things have become so commercialized, so sanitized, so generic on every level that it's almost impossible to find something that's actually worth listening to.
Yeah. I mean, if you look at the lyrics of like, you know, mainstream modern day music, it's just like one line repeated 90 times and it's, you know, the same beat and there's nothing changes. There's no technicalities behind it, you know,
right.
The movie Idiocracy, I think we're kind of along that path. So yeah, it's happening.
I would like to see some
modern day music. Peasants, I have two questions. My first one's about art. These days, you know, art, like books and movies and whatnot, they're really, I feel, not really giving a lot of thought to the message. And a lot of it is, don't get me wrong. But most of it is like, you know, copying off of other people's ideas and not really caring what message they're putting into the world, you know, money. But, you know, the message that honestly teaches people.
I don't know. I kind of almost feel like the opposite, where like people place way too much emphasis on what's the message of this? What message is this sending? It's like, I don't really, you know, I mean, to me, if I'm watching a movie, I don't care about the fucking message. I care about telling a compelling story with interesting characters. You know, if there's a good, I mean, if there's a message that's, you know, good or interesting, that's fine, that's a plus, but that shouldn't be the main thrust of things. And it seems like everywhere I go, people are talking about, I'm this media critic, like Anita Sarkeesian type people, where there's like, oh, well, I'm going to tell you what the message of this shit really is. And of course, it's like the vigilant Christian. He sees the Illuminati everywhere. And then we had a guy on last week that saw, that sees racism everywhere. And then we have
subjective.
The feminist that sees sexism everywhere.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like, a message is kind of a very subjective thing. And I almost feel like there's too much emphasis placed on it right now, as opposed to not enough.
They are going to the movies to be taught or not. Subconsciously, they're learning the message. If the main character, you know, says something or does something, you know, they're going to pick up on that, especially if they have that character as a role model. So my question is, do you think that people should start actively making large amounts of art for the intent purpose of teaching a specific message?
I think that would be a recipe for some really shitty art, honestly. I feel like if you're going to write characters not based on honestly writing a character that comes from a genuine perspective, but instead you're trying to beat someone over the head with some stupid message, you start writing like Ayn Rand at that point, and it just becomes a bunch of pretentious fucking nonsense.
All right, lightning round questions. Here we go.
Hello, drunken peasants. I have a question for you, obviously. Anyway, for a very long time, as I'm sure both of you do, I considered freedom of speech to be the first most important right on a list going in descending order of importance. But somewhat recently, I've started to question that and said...
Is this guy's accent for real?
I don't know.
I'm just gonna put that a little bullshit.
It sounds contrived as fuck to me. I've never heard anyone actually talk like this.
Sounds like the rich people on Gilligan's Island.
Right, you know, it doesn't sound like a I don't know.
Maybe he has an underbite. Okay.
Okay.
Right, which is not often talked.
Right.
I think it's taking more of a self-evident truth and is often just protected because it seems obvious. And so maybe I should place this right at a zero.
All right, I'm skipping it. I can't even handle it.
Yeah.
Anymore.
I can't even like listen to what he's saying because of his accent.
My question for you today is,
Bandage.
What do you guys think about the non-aggression principle? It's a big part of libertarian philosophy, and I'm interested in hearing your response.
Look at the sign he has up on the wall there.
Ban TJ.
Yeah.
Ban TJ.
Ban TJ.
Non-aggression principle. I don't know exactly how that, what the parameters of the definition of that are, so I'm gonna look it up actually, because I kind of have a general idea, but I don't want to like misstate something and then have a bunch of fucking libertarians jump on my shit. All right, non-aggression principle. The non-aggression principle, also called the non-aggression axiom, is a moral principle that many popular strains of modern libertarianism, the NAP, asserts that aggression, a term defined by proponents of NAP as any encroachment or on property rights, is always illegitimate no matter the consequences of abstaining from encroachment on property rights in a given context. Okay, it pretty much means what I thought. So, basically, the libertarian concept of aggression is like, you know, we're going to tax you, and then we're going to use your taxes to, you know, build roads or to give welfare to these people who are, like, extremely poor, or we're going to put that into, you know, Social Security or whatever. It's, like, basically, like, the idea that all taxation is inherently... an aggression against the person being taxed. I think that a lot of people in America would probably find a great deal of emotional appeal in that, because it's a very like anti-tax society. It's like, you know, the Tea Party stands for taxed enough already. Tea, right? You know, I just don't understand what the alternative is to having taxation. It's like, are we all just going, I mean, like, even if we all just, like, let's all just get together and decide we're going to maintain the infrastructure of America, like, out of our own pockets voluntarily. I just don't think it would work. If I thought it would work, then I would probably be an advocate, but I just don't think it would. I think most people have to be compelled in order to do that. And since I'm aiming for, like, the Star Trek future where we're ultra-progressive and have advanced technology that enables us to explore the cosmos, I can't exactly get behind a libertarian philosophy that I think is going to stunt the technological and social development of the human race.
Yeah.
Ditto.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, super low volume. I still can't hear him.
Yeah, neither can I.
Fuck that guy.
I know.
I wonder if he vapes.
Yeah. You shouldn't do that, Pistol. It's bad for you.
It's bad for you.
Yeah, I'm pretty much going to die tomorrow.
Right.
Good.
Hello, Double Penetration Podcast. I have two questions today. Don't you think that if life on Earth can be so good at survival, such as the tardigrade, which can survive in space, couldn't it evolve to suit the conditions on, say, Venus, or Mars, or even Pluto? Maybe microbial life at the very least? My second...
Why is Stephen Hawking always asking us questions?
You think he'd already know the answer.
You're right.
Question is...
He's admitting I'm smarter than him.
If space is big enough, wouldn't it be possible for characters and events in works of fiction to be a reality somewhere out there?
Sure.
Thank you guys for answering my questions.
You know, I mean, it goes even further than that. Like, if you accept, like, the multiverse and you believe there's, like, all of these different possible universes out there with different laws
in my
physics
mouth,
and
TJ.
Shit. You know. What happened?
Oh, I was just continuing what he would have said next.
Okay.
TJ, spit in my mouth.
Or we're learning what Ben really wants.
Or we're learning what actually happens after the cameras go off.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, there might be like the shit you read in books might actually be happening somewhere. It's possible.
Absolutely.
Yeah, there's no way to say that it's 100% not true because, you know.
Yeah, no definitive answer one way or the other. It's just kind of like, that could be.
And you know. And our reality could be a fictional universe in some
It'd be
some
a pretty
other...
boring book, actually. Yeah. But
all right, next one.
Hello, drunken peasants. I have two things that I want to know your opinion on. Number one is, do you think that kids that grow up into a religious household are disadvantaged in a way that they don't get to go out into the world and experience religions?
No, because I was raised, I guess not in the same type of religious household that a lot of other people are. It wasn't that extreme, but I still was, and I still went to religious schools, and being part of that actually made me want to explore other religions even more. You know, I find that the people who grow up secular and then find religion later in life become the more zealous Christians, honestly.
Well, I had an atheistic upbringing, and I started, like, reading about different religions and stuff when I was, like, 15. But I didn't really care about joining any of them. I was just, like, what drives people to believe in these things, yeah. I guess.
I was never even fascinated with religion that much, but I like to argue with religious people. So I learned about religion basically just so I could argue about it on the internet.
Oh, okay. Well, it worked out for you.
Oh, is there anything like that? And number two is... I have a friend who constantly changes religions and sexuality sometimes.
I knew that was coming. I knew the sexuality part was coming. I don't know why. I just like predicted it in my head.
Like one day he'll be Christian and straight, and another day he'll be Muslim and homosexual.
What? His friend is...
I feel like your friend is like... Something. Or just trolling him hardcore, maybe. I don't know.
that is a possibility, yeah.
I don't even know how to answer that, but we got two more questions. Move on to the next one.
Hello,
pansexual polytheist.
One question to you is, health insurance companies denying health claims? Is a follow-up question.
Something about health insurance companies denying health claims.
Something about it, I don't know. I didn't hear what the actual question was.
Oh, okay, we'll do it one more time.
Yeah, we'll just answer his second question.
All right.
To this, what do you think of people who are dying not being able to get organs because of people not being organ donors?
I don't know.
Well, it's the people's choice to donate and if there's not enough people donating organs, then... That sucks, but I mean, you're not going to force people to donate their organs.
Right.
So.
Yeah.
Okay, last one. This one's called Dumb Face Man Ask Questions.
Neat.
Okay, Drunken Peasant. Ben, TJ, Scoopy.
Scoopy.
That's about it. Fuck your guests.
Wow.
Oh, fuck me then. Right,
I know.
Fuck you.
If you have any. And fuck you, Scotty, if you're not there.
He covered everybody there.
Yep.
This guy thinks ahead.
My question is, it's directed at Scotty, but Ben and TJ, you can answer it for Scotty.
We will.
Are you ready to take the new cocky?
The new cocky. That was Gail's...
from the Jesuits?
Jizz bomb.
Yeah, the nuke that just covers jizz everywhere.
Are you ready to take...
Take it!
Jesuit sperm bomb. Yeah, Scotty's ready.
I'm ready.
She's you ready. Pistol's ready. Scotty's ready.
I'll be standing on my deck with my mouth open to the sky.
Oh, yeah. The new cocky.
Yeah.
It's a protein shake replacement.
Could you think of a better way for, you know, society to crumble? A giant new cocky bomb.
It'd be entertaining, that's for sure.
Yeah.
It'd be like that scene in Ghostbusters where the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man explodes and everyone's covered in marshmallow.
Are you a god?
But it would be cum instead.
Marshmallow.
Right. Exactly.
So we're about to wrap up the show. Everybody go to our channel, subscribe, youtube.com/drunkenpeasants. It's back. We're going to start using it again soon. You can visit our Patreon, patreon.com/DP, to support the show. A lot of good perks there. You can check them out there. Thank you so much for being on, Pistol. You can anyone that wants to check out her channel, The Tech Syndicate, you can go to the description of the video and check it out.
Mm-hmm.
If they're into technology and computers.
Who isn't?
I don't know. Console peasants.
Amish people.
Console peasants. Not the PC master race, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Everyone's dead. All right, show's over. Everyone go away.
All right.
Bye.
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 We hung up on her.
She's gone.
Yep.
And we're gone, too.
We are gone.
Peace.
We will be back on Friday. Are we going to tease our guest on Friday really quick before we go off the air?
Oh, yeah. Rageaholic.
Rageaholic will be on the next show. Fuck all of you. Good night.